Raider Nation, what's going on? You guys are watching the Raiders Report, and we're coming at you live here on Monday because we have some breaking news. The Las Vegas Raiders have fired General Manager Mike Mayock. Now, there were some rumblings coming through today because the Raiders announced that they're going to, you know, be interviewing some new candidates, and as soon as I was like, wait a minute, they're interviewing some new candidates, something could end up happening. Now, we're going to be breaking down a lot of news and rumors on today's show. I'm going to tell you about some of those candidates. We're also going to be talking about some of the guys that they could potentially be looking at as the next head coach. Now, Mike Mayock was let go, but Rich Bisaccia, as it stands right now, is still the head coach. To make sure that you don't miss anything the entire week, hit that sub button, hit those notifications, and if you're driving, buckle up because it's going to be a bumpy ride here for the next few weeks. Now, here was a tweet that came through from Ian Rapoport at 4:58 p.m. Raiders general manager Mike Mayock was informed that he won't be retained, sources said. John Gruden resigned in October, Mayock now out in January. It definitely is pretty crazy from top to bottom, considering the fact if you would have told me a few months ago, back in August, heck, even in September, even in the beginning of October, that the Las Vegas Raiders would have made the playoffs, that the Raiders would have won their final four games to get into the playoffs, and John Gruden and Mike Mayock would no longer be with the team, I would have said, whatever you're drinking, I'll take two extra one of those things, because I don't think anybody would have ever predicted it. Now, Adam Schefter, he also went out and he tweeted that unlike Mike Mayock, Raiders interim head coach Rich Bisaccia remains with the team at this time, but Las Vegas has submitted interview requests for at least one head coach candidate. Now, what you guys do, this is what the Raiders Report here is all about. My job is to keep you up to date. My job is to be able to provide free content. So to the 1,300 people that are watching right now, what is your one-word reaction to Mayock being fired? You only get one word. If you are going to curse, I always say, I'm going to warn you because, well, YouTube's going to go ahead and block it. So give me those one-word reactions. I see some finalies coming in from Austin. I see a good coming in from Noah. Amazing from Michael. Yes, it's the right move. That's a few extra words. I also see some people that are a little bit upset. My one-word reaction, and guess what? I'm going to hyphenate it so I can get it to work. It's buckle up. And the reason why it's buckle up is because of this. When you really talk about everything that's about to go down for this Raiders franchise, general manager, head coach, offensive coordinator, defensive coordinator, even Derek Carr, I released a video earlier this morning about what the future for him could potentially look like. For people who are not dedicated to this team, an easy way to make sure that you never miss anything, again, is to make sure that you're subscribed to the Raiders Report. But there is going to be a lot of changes. I know Mark Davis has been talking to some people, and, you know, we've been waiting here and there, waiting for extra news to come out. But this has been the plan all along. Davis said way, way long ago, months ago, that the plan was this. When the Raiders season was over is when you're going to start seeing some of these dominoes start to fall. And Mike Mayock now being let go is the very first of many dominoes that are going to happen here. And I can guarantee you this, we're going to go ahead, we're going to keep you guys up to date. So keep giving me those one-word reactions to Mike Mayock being fired. Now, we are live here on the show, and I appreciate everyone who's tuned in because it means you got your noties on. If you're happy that I decided to come in on my off day and do a live video, hey, shout out to y'all. If you could like the video, I would definitely appreciate it. We also have some super chats, and remember, if you guys want to get featured, if you want to get a shout out here on the show, if you super chat, like Felipe Mendia, like Mr. Greekin, we can do our best to go ahead, get you up on the screen, and give you guys a little bit of airtime. I know I really appreciate it. Let's go to one of my homies here, Mystic. Who's the guy in your picture? Ed Dodds comes from a winning culture from the Colts. Doesn't seem like a bad idea. Harbaugh for head coach. Gus for DC. Rich for special teams. I mean, I don't mind a lot of those ideas. The issue is this. I don't see that being necessarily the case from top to bottom. Let's go now go to Felipe Mendia. All right, Mitch. Who's your GM we should hire? Well, I said yesterday or 2 days ago, I don't even know, I'm losing track of my days at this point, that the top guy that I would want the Raiders to go out and get is actually Lewis Riddick. And I truly believe that since Mike Mayock has been let go, Riddick is going to be entered. But as it stands right now, the Raiders have only requested to interview two general managers. The first one, Dane Ziegler, Director of Player Personnel, Ziegler for the New England Patriots. And then Ed Dodds, assistant GM from Indianapolis. from people who I trust, from people that I hear, it does sound like Ed Dodds is the front runner to be the next general manager of the Raiders. But with that being said, when you look at some of the people that the Raiders are potentially looking at in terms of interview requests to be the next head coach, you got Rich Bisaccia, Gus Bradley, Leslie Frazier, Todd Bowles, Jerod Mayo. The top guy, the guy who I hear is going to be the most likely to be the next Raiders head coach, he's actually not on this list yet. In fact, a very good source close to me, James Yoder, said that he really truly believes that Jim Harbaugh has got his eyes on the Las Vegas Raiders. And I told you guys a week ago, told you guys maybe even 2 weeks ago, if I was able mathematically to make my own odds, you guys know I'm terrible at math, Jim Harbaugh would be the front runner to be the next head coach here for the Las Vegas Raiders. Now, he's the betting favorite. There was also a rumor circulating a few weeks ago that, you know, Harbaugh went silent, that he didn't show up to a meeting to discuss his old contract with the Michigan Wolverines, and that apparently the Raiders could potentially be planning to offer him $12 million a year. I was asked yesterday, 2 days ago, who is the front runner to be the next head coach of the Raiders? It is Jim Harbaugh, and a close second is Rich Bisaccia, and then in a distant third, I actually don't have that good of an answer for y'all. Let's go to another Super Chat. This one's coming in from Mashissimo Locke. They failed first rounders are blamed on Mayock since Gruden is gone. Yeah, I mean, I definitely think this is one of those things where, again, Mike Mayock was said that, hey, I want to go ahead, I want to bring this guy in because he's supposed to be this draft guru, yet Cleveland Furl, as much as I like Clee and I respect Clee, he's absolutely been a bust. I like Josh Jacobs, but the easiest position to be able to replace in the draft usually is at the running back position. Jonathan Abram, he hasn't been worth a first-round pick whatsoever. And then, you know, this is where it kind of gets sticky because obviously Henry Ruggs, I think, was trending in the right direction. Damon Arnett, in fact, he just got released today on Monday by the Miami Dolphins, and Damon is a guy that I never liked that the Raiders went out and got. And Alex Leatherwood, even though he started out as a right tackle, took him a little while to get his feet wet, I actually think that he's going to end up being a pretty good pro, but he absolutely struggled this season. You're just going to have to be a little bit more patient with Leatherwood, right? So let's go to another Super Chat. This one's coming in from Sean John, my favorite sweatpants. Sounds like a house cleaning is coming. New GM, head coach, quarterback, OCDC, another 20s of bad football. I mean, I hope not, right? I mean, if I have anything to say, hey, Raiders, if you want to hire me and my chat sports team, 10 years, $99 million guaranteed, cheaper than Gruden. Let's go to Peyton. Hey, Mitch, just tested positive for COVID. Listening to you makes me feel better. Well, I mean, if we could just maybe send a shot of me to every single person in the United States and the world, maybe that's all it takes. I don't know at this point. Peyton, glad you're watching. Let's go to PS4 Films, more of an Xbox guy. Who do you want as head coach, Mitch? The guy that I want as the next head coach is the guy who's going to lead us to the to a Super Bowl. My top head coach candidates continue to be Brian Daboll would be OC. Jim Harbaugh is starting to, I don't want to say catch feelings for Harbaugh, but he's definitely won in a lot of areas, and I know he's right now the front runner. To me, it's either Papa Bisaccia, it's that, or I'm going to go with Daboll and Jim Harbaugh. Those are probably my top three candidates right now. Let's go to Raider Quan. What up, man? Who was the better GM, Mayock or Reggie? Oh, man. I'll actually probably say Reggie for the simple fact of Reggie at least gave us 2014, right? Like, he gave us a hell of a 2014 draft class. So, for that, I guess I'm going to have to go ahead and say Reggie because Mayock, at this current juncture for what we have, not very good. Let's go to Celestial Lean. She sent in a $5. Brother, I appreciate you. Appreciate everyone tuning in. Let's go to George Lopez, the real George Lopez. Gruden wanted the general manager he can control. Also, I think the OC is next. Yeah, I mean, Greg Olson, we knew he was going to be out the door. I think Tom Cable could be another name to keep in mind. But just because Gruden wanted the GM he can control, I get that. But that also goes to Mark Davis, giving Gruden 51% control. So no matter what Mayock said, Gruden had the authority to lay down the hammer and basically, maybe that's where knock on wood if you're with me came from, but overall get the final say of what happens to this organization. Way, way too much power in just one dude. Let's go to, I'm Batman. Please, for the love of whatever God there may be, whoever comes in as GM and head coach, do not blow up this team. Well, luckily, if we find some villain trying to blow up the city, I know a guy tries to protect Gotham. Maybe you know who he is, Batman. But, yeah, I'm with you, dude. I want to bring in a GM who's able to do the right things, who can help build some solid guys. And I think Mayock was put in a rough situation because I actually do think Gruden is more to blame than Mayock. However, that's just kind of the way this is going to go, and I really truly believe that Mark has his eye set on somebody. So for those of you that are just joining us now here on the Raiders Report, because we have over 2,500 people watching, if you're a diehard Raider fan, if you bleed silver and black, I want you to go ahead and like the video right now. We only got 377. Let's get to 1,000 likes on this bad boy. I got some beers ready to crack open. So we went live here on the show. We always go live for breaking news. Remember to subscribe. Remember to turn on those notifications. That way you're not tuning in. You're like, wait a minute, what happened? This is what happened. The Las Vegas Raiders fired general manager Mike Mayock Monday afternoon. And unfortunately for him, we'll see what comes next. But this is where the new process starts. Mark Davis said when they let go of John Gruden a few months ago that they were going to wait to start making some changes once the season is over. It pains me to say it. Also, Jerome Bugger, F you, man, you screwed us. But that's besides the point. What is now is this. You got the offseason. We're trending that way. Fired after three seasons as the team's general manager. Now, I'll tell you this, man. I am super, super excited to announce we got a new sponsor here on the Raiders Report. I know Chuck, anytime I say fetch, he's super excited. You guys are going to be even more excited. So this is a free-to-download app. All you got to do is go to chatsports.com/fetch. Now, some of you are probably wondering, well, Mitch, what the heck is the Fetch Rewards app? Has anybody ever bought anything before? Have you ever gotten a receipt? I don't know about you. I am saving all of my receipts because of this awesome app here. It's super easy to use. And if you go to chatsports.com/fetch, and then if you use promo code Raiders, can you remember it if you can't? It's literally on my chest. You're going to get 3,000 bonus points. Now, you earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant. You redeem points for gift cards and other rewards. So imagine this. Let's just say you go to CVS. You buy X amount of dollars worth of stuff. If you scan that receipt and you put it on the Fetch Rewards app, you are going to be rewarded. You can get gift cards to Walmart, Amazon, CVS, favorite restaurants. You can get all of that awesome stuff. So when the cashier asks you, do you want a receipt? Say yes. Say yes. Or you can even take the email receipt. You can also scan that if, you know, you're trying to save the trees, because I don't know what CVS is doing. But the next time we go through a crisis, as long as that receipt is, I can use that to wipe my you-know-what. That's how crazy it is. So one more time. Code Raiders, chatsports.com/fetch. And again, I know you guys like free. It's free to download. And if you guys could go ahead and do it, this is a great way also to get some extra stuff coming back to you. 3,000 bonus points. You're going to be able to get gift cards. You're going to be able to do some fun stuff. Who knows? Maybe when next time you're out in Vegas, getting ready to watch the Raiders, you earn enough points. Get some free stuff from Amazon. Get some free stuff from here and there. Code Raiders, chatsports.com/fetch. Fetch. All right, y'all, let me know down in the comment section, who should be the next Raiders general manager? I know when it really comes down to it, some of these names are, you know, maybe not the easiest to be able to wrap our mind around. I'll say that right now the top three leading candidates are Lewis Riddick. So if you want Lewis Riddick, I want you to go down in the comment section right now and type LR. If you want Ed Dodds, who is one of the people that the Raiders are requesting, I want you to go ahead and type ED. If you have ED, call a doctor. Now, also, the last guy we're going to go ahead and talk about, whose name is escaping me, who's the other guy that they're going to interview for general manager? Lewis Riddick, Ed Dodds, and then the Patriots. Ziegler, yeah, DZ. So DZ, LR, or ED, who should be the next Raiders GM? If you have somebody else that you have in mind, please go ahead and let me know. It's time for one of my favorite parts of the show, the interactiveness. Now, if you're not subscribed, you might not be able to comment on the show. So we got Guantan. He's going to go Lewis Riddick. Mayo, you're talking about for in terms of a head coach. We got Kite says DZ. ED from Jose. CLR says Lewis Riddick. Got another Lewis Riddick coming in from Steve Jones. Ocean Water, Riddick. Guantanamo Bay, Lewis Riddick. As you can see, a lot of people want Lewis Riddick. Let's go to Christian J. Rivera. Harbaugh, Adams, a lot of vets resign and draft an offensive line, and Derek Carr, make or break year for an extension. Here's the issue. From people that I've been hearing, if you're going to bring back Derek Carr, you're going to have to extend him before the season even starts. So I know we talk a lot about DC, $19.9 million. I don't think that number is going to have any factor whatsoever. It sounds like Derek Carr and his team are saying, if you want me back, you got to pay me more money and you got to give me a longer contract. If that's what you want, that's not what I want. The video I made earlier today said this: I will have Derek Carr back at 19.9, or I will trade Derek Carr for multiple picks, hopefully two first-round picks. But yeah, I like Harbaugh and Adams. Let's go to Celestian Leon. Here's another five. Appreciate you, dude. Thank you for all the content and the amazing news, and keep up all the good work, and keep giving us up. All right, well, Celestial, I appreciate you, and everyone out there, if you're wondering why you should subscribe to the Raiders Report, it's because comments like this, because we built a pretty awesome group around here. Let's go to Shane. Shane says, I've earned 100 since using Fetch. There you go. See, Shane knows it. Chatsports.com/Fetch. Free to download the app. That way you guys can get set up. I mean, I'm telling you, it's super, super easy to use, and you're already going to go out and buy stuff. So imagine you're buying stuff. So for anybody out there that's got a credit card, it's basically like getting points back, right? You get like 1%, 3%, 5%. You're like, all right, I can get extra rewards for things that I'm already going to buy. That's literally what the Fetch thing does. Let's go to Mr. Wombat. So we just going to act like Mike's late-round selections have all been trash. Okay, stupid decision to let him go, in my opinion. No, I don't think anybody's sitting here saying that. I mean, obviously, Max Crosby has been an absolute monster. Divine Diablo has started to come through together a little bit. But then Nate Hobbs, he's also been pretty good. You know, you're not really going to be able to define that. Hunter Renfro's been very successful. But here's the biggest issue, Mr. Wombat. People don't just talk about fourth-rounders, fifth-rounders. When they hit, that's great. People focus on the first-round miss. And when you have the amount of first-round misses Mayock's had, go back in time, look at a lot of the free agency signings. I mean, you want Corey Littleton, that one hasn't worked. Trent Brown, that didn't work. The trade for Antonio Brown, that didn't work. Look at all the trades, look at all the signings, look at everything all captivated into one. And if you can honestly sit here and say that Mike Mayock and John Gruden did a good job, I'm going to say that you're crazy. I'm not saying that Mayock deserved to get fired. That's not what I'm saying. But I can also understand this, that I can understand that they wanted to go ahead and move on. Let's go to ZAI. Renfro said in a recent press conference, continuity is key. If we break this squad, except for some O-line upgrades, we're setting ourselves back. Now, you're not totally wrong, but here's the other aspect of that whole thing, right? The Raiders have over, I believe, 33 free agents this season, like guys like Casey Hayward. I mean, Casey Hayward was an absolute stud for this team. You're going to have Nicholas Marr. There's going to be a lot of free agents. There's going to be a lot of stuff, and you're right. Continuity is very key, but I've also learned this, that we've seen multiple times from guys like Nelson Agholor. If you get the right pieces, you're going to be able to fit right in with us. And at the end of the day, I think we're going to be able to find guys that want to win, because who doesn't want to win, right? Let's go to David Zahn. Got a bigger super chat coming in from my dude. I don't know the names. Say that again. There are a few teams in the league that are always stacked. We should start there. Green Bay, Pittsburgh, Patriots, someone from somewhere with proven sustained success. My two cents. I don't disagree with that whatsoever, but Green Bay, they have Aaron Rodgers. Pittsburgh, yes, Mike Tomlin, for what he's been able to do there, a lot of success. Patriots, they had Tom Brady, Bill Belichick, those type of guys, obviously, they don't really grow on trees. But there's going to be some people out there, like Ed Dodds has had a lot of success with Indianapolis. Obviously, Ziegler as well with New England has had a lot of success. Lewis Riddick's going to be another interesting candidate as well. David Zahn, I appreciate the super chat. We're going to be going ahead now and breaking down this move from a little bit more here, probably the next 10 to 12 minutes. Then we're going to go ahead and answer more questions here on the Raiders Report. So every other super chat. So Zachary, Jeff, David, and then Ben that just came in. We will get to some more super chats. We're going to get to some more stuff, but I am going to be breaking down all this Mike Mayock news for everyone who is just joining in for probably the next 10 to 12 minutes. So if you have more questions, super chat, or go ahead and use hashtag Raiders. This is why you subscribe to the Raiders Report. Why? Because we come at you breaking news on a Monday. The Las Vegas Raiders have fired general manager Mike Mayock. Now, I promise you guys this all the time. News, rumors, 100% free. And even if it's my day off, I don't care. I'm giving you guys the content that you desire. So hit that sub button and turn on those notifications. That way you don't miss a thing. Now, the Raiders Report today is presented by a brand new sponsor that I am very, very excited to be able to talk about. Major shout out to Fetch Rewards. If anybody out there wants to go ahead and download this free app, all you got to do is go to chatsports.com/fetch. That's going to get you 3,000 bonus points. Now, for those of you wondering, well, why would I go ahead and download this? Has anybody ever bought anything? Has the cashier ever said, hey, do you want a receipt? Answer yes to that, and then you basically submit your receipts on this app where you can then get extra points, then get extra gift cards from places like Amazon, CVS. It's an awesome app. That link's going to be available for you on the comments and in the description. So the Las Vegas Raiders decided to move on from Mike Mayock after three seasons. Now the new search is going to go ahead and begin. We're going to talk about some guys that they've already requested to interview at general manager. We're also going to be breaking down some of the people that they've requested to interview as a potential head coach. Now the news broke on Monday, and I always like to say, and I say it all the time here, where there's smoke, there's probably going to end up being some fire. And a lot of smoke started happening on IG, on Twitter, all these places. And Ian Rapoport went ahead and tweeted, "General Manager Mike Mayock was informed that he won't be retained," sources said. "John Gruden resigned in October. Mayock now out in January." Then Adam Schefter, he chimed in with his two cents as well. "Unlike Mike Mayock, Raiders interim head coach Rich Bisaccia remains with the team at this time, but Las Vegas has submitted interview requests for at least one head coaching candidate." Now, yes, the one head coach candidate, which obviously we're going to get to here. They've also requested four other head coaching candidates, which they did probably about 2 months ago, maybe a month ago. But this is what the Raiders Report's about. It's about giving you guys news, about giving you guys rumors. It's just about being diehard fans trying to collaborate together. So this is the opportunity where you guys can shine. I want you to go down in the comments section right now, and I want you to give me that one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. It can be a positive comment. It can be a negative comment. Whatever you're feeling is that initial knee-jerk reaction. My one-word reaction when I heard this, I was kind of like, buckle up. Not that I knew 100% that it was going to happen, but I started talking to some people, some of my friends in the industry. They were like, hey, I really truly believe that this is going to end up happening. So when I say buckle up, I mean it's going to be a very, very interesting next week or two. I mean, you could even look in 3 weeks, 4 weeks. The entire offseason is just going to be a time that I'm telling you, you're going to want to be subscribed here. You're going to be making sure that you have everything going on, because the next time that the Raiders announce who they're going to hire as a GM, I guarantee you this, I'm going to be going live here on the Raiders Report. Now, I know I talked to you guys at the top of the show about Fetch, but I do want to say it one more time. Chuck loves this app, chatsports.com/fetch. It's free to download. You can kind of see how the app works here on the right side of me. You can take a picture of your receipt. You then upload it, and you can get rewarded for all of your shopping. So basically, let's just say you go ahead and you spend some money at a CVS. You scan that receipt. Then you can earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant. Like, guys, I'm telling you right now, super, super easy. So go to chatsports.com/fetch. Make sure you use promo code Raiders. Can you remember that? I know. It's right here on my sweatshirt. Promo code Raiders at chatsports.com/fetch to get 3,000 bonus points. So earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant, and then redeem those points for gift cards and other awesome rewards. Now, when you talk about Mike Mayock, everyone likes to say, all right, this guy was supposed to be, you know, I don't know, this draft guru from top to bottom, he could help us out. But, I mean, let's face it. These first-round picks, not so good. In fact, at times they almost take my breath away. Cleveland Furrell, that's been an absolute bust. I love Josh Jacobs. He ran hell of a game this past week up against the Bengals. But running back's the easiest position to be able to replace. Jonathan Abram has absolutely not been worth a first-round pick, and he's going to be a guy that they say they're going to turn down his fifth-year option. Then in 2020, Henry Ruggs, trending in the right direction. Obviously, I can't really put that one against Mayock, but, you know, it is what it is now. Damon Arnett, if anybody watched more than 10 minutes of film on Arnett, and Mike Mayock said that they did more research than anybody, I foolishly would say then you're crazy for honestly drafting Arnett in the first or second round. He's been a bust, and in fact, he was released by the Miami Dolphins today. And then Alex Leatherwood, another player that I had a round two grade on, thought they reached on him just a little bit, but when you add up the draft and you add up some of the trades that did not work, the big-time signings like a Trent Brown in free agency, the Antonio Brown trade, they've had a lot of things that simply, you have to realize, have not worked in Mike Mayock's favor. Now, in terms of some other general manager interview requests, they've had Dane Ziegler, who is director of player personnel of the New England Patriots, Ed Dodds, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. As this time, these are the only two general manager requests that the Raiders have put in. I said on my show on Sunday that the top guy that I want the Raiders to go out and at least put in 2 cents with is Lewis Riddick. I know Lewis Riddick would be interested in being a general manager in the National Football League. I think it's only a matter of time until you start seeing some news around him. But as it stands right now, the leading candidate to be the next general manager of the Raiders is Ed Dodd, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. Now, if you don't like those two names there, I anticipate most people who are watching are probably going to go ahead and type LR for Lewis Riddick. I want to know, Who should be the next Raiders general manager? If anybody wants to say my name, hey, I'll submit it. I'm totally down to do it. I'd be more than happy to try to get this team on the right track. So who should be the next Raiders general manager? Now, we are going to shift our ship here to the head coach because we're going to be talking about Rich Bisaccia a whole lot. And if anybody ever wants to hit me up with anything, remember, you can always hit me up on IG at MitchellRen365. And on top of that, I've been posting a lot more news, a lot more just rumblings and stuff that I'm hearing on my Twitter and IG. So please don't be afraid to give me a follow. Now, here's another tweet coming in here from Ian Rapoport that says, the Raiders have a top in-house candidate in DeJuan Daniels, assistant director of player personnel. Mark Davis still plans to interview interim Rich Bisaccia for the head job. Crazy the team made the playoffs despite Gruden resigning, Ruggs, injuries, and so much more. Which, you're 100% right. I mean, the Raiders are the first team in 60 years. Yes, first team in 60 years, basically the first team since Super Bowl era, to make the playoffs when another coach on that team was let go. Also, the Raiders are only the second team since the 2000 Alliance to win at least 9 games. I know the Raiders won 10, but at least 9 games. Like, that's how great Rich Bisaccia has been for this team. Now, in terms of some early head coach interviews, you have Bisaccia, Gus Bradley, Leslie Frazier, Todd Bowles. The four names that you see right here, these were announced probably, I'm going to say, about a month and a half ago. And then the new name that just popped up today on Monday was Jerod Mayo, inside linebacker of the New England Patriots. I could also see some extra names like, I think if you don't interview Brian Daboll, Kellen Moore, even extra names like a Byron Leftwich, if Mike Tomlin's available, Sean Payton, if he becomes available. I mean, there's going to be a lot of big names out there to potentially look at to be that next Raiders head coach. The issue is this, and it's not even an issue. If you were to ask me, Mitch, what's your gut feeling? And I'm feeling my gut right now, and it's who's going to be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. I've talked to very reliable sources, people even like James Yoder, who's very well connected with the Michigan Wolverines, and he said Jim Harbaugh right now is eyeing the Las Vegas Raiders. He also said that he's eyeing the Giants, but I've heard from multiple people that Jim Harbaugh could end up being absolutely the next head coach of the Raiders. And then you go out and you look at the Vegas odds. You look at all these other odds out there, and Harbaugh is the betting favorite to be the Raiders' next head coach. Now, there was a rumor circulating about a week and a half ago, 2 weeks, that the Raiders could potentially offer him $12 million. This also was kind of piggybacking off of another report that said that Harbaugh's gone silent in the Michigan football room, that, you know, apparently he didn't show up to a meeting in terms of discussing his long-term contract. I've been saying it for weeks. I've been turning my page on the fact that, hey, I actually wouldn't mind Jim Harbaugh. Now, this is a pretty interesting tweet. For those of you, I know, for those of you that don't know who Jumbo Elliott is, he was an old teammate of Harbaugh for like 14 seasons. Little Birdie says Coach Harbaugh eyeing the Raiders and the Giants. All I'm saying is this, for an old friend, a good friend of Harbaugh, and an old teammate of his, all I got to say is for him to be tweeting out stuff like this, to me means that it's, you know, pretty well that he knows somebody, and the guy that he knows is Harbaugh. So, Elliott was a four-year teammate of Harbaugh at Michigan from 1983 to 86, two-time All-American, a 14-year NFL player with the Giants and Jets, and a 1993 Pro Bowl. He's very well connected, and he wouldn't just throw out a tweet like this if he didn't actually know. Now, if you were to ask me right now, who is the top head coach candidate for the Raiders, the most likely is Jim Harbaugh. He has had success wherever he has gone, which not a lot of coaches can say. When you look at the job that Harbaugh was able to do in San Diego, yeah, it was actually his first head coaching gig. He turned San Diego into a winning team, where they went 11-1, 11-1 the final 2 years. He took Stanford, that program, to a winning record. He took the Michigan Wolverines of late. They just took down Ohio State. He did it with San Francisco. They were 44-19-1 overall. If you were to ask me who is the front runner to be the next Raiders head coach, it is Jim Harbaugh. But I also will go ahead and say this. I want Rich Bisaccia back in that locker room. I want Rich Bisaccia back at Allegiant Stadium. I tweeted out at MitchellRens365 that Rich Bisaccia hand-wrote messages to every single Raiders player thanking them for basically just being dedicated to the game. I'm not sitting here saying that I want Bisaccia back as the head coach because, to be honest, I don't. but I would want Bisaccia back as the special teams coordinator, as your assistant head coach, and to reward him for really being a glue guy. I mean, when you hear people like Max Crosby, Derek Carr speak as highly as they do about Bisaccia, that goes a long way with me. So keep Bisaccia, give him extra money, make him that assistant head coach, and let's not go down a rabbit hole where you make one guy just the be-all in terms of a head coach. This is, needs to be a collective unit. Now, I appreciate everyone that's made it this far in the video. I know you're probably going to get ready for some Monday Night Football. Maybe you're going to go out and buy some food. If you buy some food, if you get a receipt, make sure you scan that. Free to download this app, chatsports.com/fetch. Just make sure you use promo code Raiders. That way you get some extra bonus points. That way you get some extra cards to go ahead and spend elsewhere. All right, y'all, go ahead. Shout out your city. Let me know where you're at. I don't know if you guys could tell, I had the worst tickle in the back of my throat, which is also top 10 weirdest things I've ever said on this show. If anybody knows what can help with a tickle in the back of my throat, please, can't wait to see what you have to say. Let me know where you guys are watching from. Shout out your city. We're going to go ahead now, and we're going to be answering some super chats, answering some questions. We've had a lot of stuff come up here on the show, and basically the more supers that come in, the more questions that we get. It's just the longer that I could stay live here on the show. I mean, like I said, today was my off day. Shout out to my team. Shout out to Harrison Graham, Chase Sr., Jeffrey Kubestein, Brett Scott, James Yoder, Tom Downey, Jeremy Biedling, Sam Brown. We got a hell of a team. Matthew Peterson. Trying to think, did I forget anyone? I don't know. But they put this entire show together. I was able to walk in today on my off day, and they were able to set it up. So major shout out to all of them. Now let's go. Shout out your city. What do we got here? What is that? Mill Petisa, California from Richard. I don't know where that is. Madera, California. Santa Monica, California from Eric. Richmond, Virginia. Derek from Erica Salazar. Laren Moss says, teamwork. Landsberg, New York. Freeland, PA. B-I-L-O-X-I. I have no idea. Biloxi. I don't know, Mississippi. We have more coming in here. Let me know where you guys are watching from, and if you want to get a shout-out here on the show. We got Southgate. We got a North Carolina coming in from Tyler the Blaze, San Jose, California, Henderson, Nevada, Salinas, California, Utah from Raider B-Dog, Porterville, California, Hartford, Vegas, baby. So keep on coming in. Shout out your city. Let me know down in the comment section. Coming up right now, we're going to do a fun little like mailbag reaction to all the Mike Mayock news. So if you want to get featured on the show, the two ways to do it, hashtag Raiders, or you can go ahead and super chat. Once Brett gives me the thumbs up, we're going to go ahead. We're going to be answering all y'all's questions for the next maybe like 15 minutes or so. And then if the questions are good, if you guys are having a good time, which, by the way, if you are having a good time right now, you're happy that we went live on the Raiders Report, please go ahead, like the video. Believe it or not, it does help us out a lot here. We are a free channel, and we do our best to be able to go ahead, keep you guys up to date on anything going on around the silver and black. So hashtag Raiders or Super Chat to get featured in this mailbag. Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report. The Las Vegas Raiders, they have moved on from general manager Mike Mayock. So what we're doing here on today's show is we're gonna react to it. This is a live instant reaction to Mike Mayock being fired from Raider Nation. So all the questions, all your comments is a knee-jerk reaction. So get ready. It's about to get wild. This first one's coming in from David Taken. I think the Raiders should re-sign Solomon Thomas, Denzel Perriman, Casey Hayward, hire Harbaugh, fire Olsen. All right, so Solomon Thomas, I would want him back to on a much cheaper contract. Denzel Perriman's not a free agent. He's still got 1 year left on his deal. Casey Hayward's probably one of your top priorities. Yes, I like Harbaugh. Olsen's gone. Get rid of Parker. Brandon, he can still at least be a good depth piece. All right, let's go to Jeff. Derek Carr looks like a Lyle Zotto with the long hair. Yeah, he definitely needs to cut. He looks like the bad guy in all the Home Alone movies. Let's go to Zachary Rossfeld. I'm going to miss Leah Mayock the most. Yeah, she just tweeted out that it's official, and I don't know. I'm going to be honest. I'm not really going to miss her all that much. I'm going to miss her dad a lot more. He was a hardworking guy. I have a lot of respect for Mike, but I know what you're trying to do with this. I'm not going to get into a trap. I think Alex is watching home with Chuck, and that's just it's a nightmare. Let's go to Ben Sandoval. Wikipedia says that Lewis Riddick is the new GM. What's up? Believe it or not, I don't know if anybody has ever heard this, but you can actually just go on Wikipedia and you can change it. I could actually be the 47th president of the United States if I got credit. Now, sure, they can change it in 5 minutes, but shout out to the people that did that. And yeah, I would love to have Lewis Riddick as the next GM. Let's go to Alex Thompson. If Mitch, I did the bet US Raiders 125 for the jersey, made my bet, got the email. Yeah, you just got to be a little bit more patient. We get hundreds and hundreds of emails. So if anybody out there hasn't already gotten the jersey hookup, chatsports.com/Raiders, promo code Raiders125 for that 125% deposit bonus. Alex, my team, we scrubbed through a whole bunch of emails. So just be patient, my man. If you haven't noticed, I post all the time of guys getting their free jersey. So I promise you, you will end up getting it. I just need you to be, you know, just as long as you follow the instructions, you know, we're going to be good. That's really what it comes down to. If you went to chatsports.com/Raiders, if you use promo code Raiders125, if you got that bet in before the Raiders and Bengals game, you're good. Nothing to worry about. If you didn't do that, then that can get us down a little bit of a rabbit hole because then I don't get credit, which means then I can't get a free jersey for y'all. So that's basically just how it works. All right, y'all, so let it out. What is your one-word reaction to Mike Mayock being fired? My one-word reaction was buckle up. Because I knew, like, there's going to be a lot of crazy stuff that ends up happening here for the Las Vegas Raiders probably over the next day or two, probably over the next week. There's going to be a lot of stuff going down. So if you haven't yet, let me know down in the comments section your one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. All right, y'all, we're going to start giving some shout-outs here to some of the Super Chats that have come in. I got Celestial Leon says, if Jim Harbaugh becomes the new head coach for the Raiders, what do we got? I actually think that Harbaugh absolutely could be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. Next GM, Thomas Dimitroff. Maybe Daniel, I'm not 100% sure. We got Ryan Decker. Who do you think the Raiders select with the first pick? Still way. You got to see what happens in free agency. You got to see what happens with Derek Carr. But we're going to be making a lot of videos about all that stuff. Appreciate you, Ryan. Jonathan Perez, I know this is not on topic, but unless DC is willing to run the ball and do whatever it takes to win, he's got to go. My vote. My vote is this. If DC is willing to stay on 19.9, I am willing to give him another shot. If not, and he wants a contract extension, trade him for at least two first-round picks. And if you can't get two first-round picks, then there's a whole other issue. But I am not extending Derek Carr. Let's go to Adam. Is Davis making these decisions on his own? I don't have a good answer. I haven't talked to Mark Davis, but it does sound like he's doing a lot of stuff. Jonathan Perez, appreciate it. Demokes, bruh, make polling bum moves. Really going after Patriots people. It's something I expect from the Lions organization. I can understand that a little bit, but we'll see what ends up happening. Let's go to Ben Jenkins. If Devin White was picked instead of Ferrell, Mike would still had his job. I actually don't know if that's even 100% sure. The Cleveland Ferrell one was really bad. Do I just say it out loud? Just go with it? The Olsen? All right, sounds good. Ben Jenkins, appreciate it. I see another people also that are typing in their Super Chats. If I don't get to them, please just hit me up on IG or on Twitter, MitchellRants365, because they are really coming in. Peter Silva, I think we should trade Carr if he can somehow sign Rodgers. I mean, if there's some way you can get an upgrade at QB, like that's what you got to do. If you can get Watson, if you get Wilson, if you can get Rodgers, yeah, I'm kind of on board for it. Demokes, this is the one I was kind of reading before. Same owner who fired a coach who took us 12-4 one year out. I get what Mark Davis is doing. I will say this. I've said for a long time, I know Al was one of the greatest ever, if not the greatest owner in all of the NFL. Like, you can really put that into the equation. Mark, though, needs people to have somewhere around him because he has really struggled. This is why you subscribe to the Raiders Report. Breaking news, whether it's around Mike Mayock. Breaking news, whether it is around Greg Olsen. To make sure that you never miss anything going on around the Las Vegas Raiders, hit that subscribe button. Turn on those notifications because there's going to be a lot of stuff that ends up happening the entire offseason. Trades, free agency signings, guys getting let go. We're going to be breaking it all down for you. So if you want to join the most watched Raiders channel in the entire world, whether it's a podcast, radio station, this is the channel. Hit that big red button that says sub and then click the notification bell underneath the video and select all. That way you guys don't miss a thing. All right, we got Ryan Decker. Chances of getting Devontae Adams. I will say that I believe that the chances of getting Devontae Adams are higher if you have Derek Carr. But also, Devontae wants to get paid, and the Raiders are going to have plenty of money to go ahead and spend. And if they really, truly want Adams, I believe they have a chance to get him. Now, I've also heard some rumors that the Green Bay Packers could potentially franchise tag him. If that happens, then you'd have to basically try to go out and trade for him, though Devontae could just say, no, I'm not getting tagged and sit out. Let's go to David Zahn. What up, my brother? This isn't surprising. Red zone inefficiency, a bit supervised. It's happening that fast. I mean, I know you're talking about Greg Olsen being let go. And again, I mean, if you watch the Raiders play, you knew. You knew this was going to happen. Olsen was just like one of those guys, like, all right, we're going to get down the field doing this. And he would just psych himself out. He would try to overthink, and his ability to not think critically is why he ultimately got let go. All right, let's go to Scoob. Glad Raiders kept Gus Bradley, best pickup. That's producer Brett goes, well, and that's kind of it. That's we're going to see. I know Bradley is somebody that they respect. I think Bradley did a good job being able to bring guys like Yannick Gakwe, Casey Hayward, Denzel Perryman. His system absolutely worked, but his system also worked because Max Crosby took a step forward. The Raiders, let me face it, they had the highest pressure rate in the NFL, lowest blitz rate, but also the Raiders were ranked dead last in red zone efficiencies and defense. That's not good. They were giving up a touchdown 81% of the time a team got into the red zone. Points per game against 26th in the league. There was times where the defense looked very good. And I'll say this, the past 5 weeks they did play at a very high level, but there were plenty of games also, and especially, I know this from a fact, I've heard from a reliable source, the fact that the Raiders got blown out in the two games against the Chiefs with a combined score of 89-23, that did not sit well with Mark Davis whatsoever. Let's go to Renee Bays Flores. Hire Lewis Riddick within the next hour, and don't even hesitate about it. Well, if I'm Lewis Riddick, I'm not going to sign the dotted line in the next hour. Why? There's going to be a lot of teams out there hunting down Lewis. I mean, Lewis is a very well-respected guy, but here's the issue, right? If you're Las Vegas and you let go of somebody like Mike Mayock, are you going to hire Lewis Riddick, who's basically like the exact same thing of what Mayock was, right? Like, he's essentially the exact same type of hire. I like Lewis. I respect Lewis. I think Lewis is a brighter mind than Mayock was, though I don't know if that's the direction the Las Vegas Raiders are going to go in. Appreciate the question. Let's go to one of my favorite fruits, PapayaMan89. Got a gut feeling Jim Harbaugh is coming to Vegas. Respect Mayock, but it's time to move on. I respect Mayock too, and I absolutely understand the move. When you look at the trades, free agency, everything that Mayock unfortunately failed in, it might not have always been him. However, when you're paired with Gruden, you're always going to be head coach, you know, GM. It kind of goes hand in hand. If one doesn't work, it's probably also going to look bad on Mayock. Now, I would have liked to see what he could have done with a draft on his own. Sure, absolutely. And yes, I'm with you. I really, truly believe that Jim Harbaugh is going to be the next head coach of the Raiders. I don't know if that announcement's going to come anytime soon. I do know this. Once the announcement is made, we're going to be going live here on the Raiders Report, whether that's keeping Bisaccia or whether that's going to be going with Jim Harbaugh. But either way, a lot of stuff, a lot of rumblings going on in Las Vegas, a lot of rumblings headed down in Henderson. Now, Papaya Man, shout out to everyone who's watching. I'm Batman. We got Jet Hopfinger, 80500, and then Duncan, 99. I see your super chats. We'll get to them here in just a sec. Let me know down in the comments, though. Who's your favorite Raiders player? And we can do current player. We can do Raider of all time. This is going to be up to y'all. It's your favorite Raiders player. For me personally, Bo Jackson's my favorite athlete of all time for the simple fact of, I know I probably said this 100 times on the show, but for the new watchers, if you can be an all-pro running back and also be an all-star in the MLB, you're just an absolute freak of nature. So that's why I respect Bo Jackson a lot. Derek Carr is probably one of my favorite Raiders. I respect Darren Waller, Hunter Renfrow. And then you look at some of those old guys like Howie Long, Jim Otto, the Ghost. I mean, you know, you go on and on and on. Those are just some of my personal favorite Raiders. Also, shout out to Tim Brown. So we are live here on the Raiders Report because the Las Vegas Raiders, they fired general manager Mike Mayock. And then basically an hour later, so the Olsen news is not 100% official. As from what I'm being told, the Olsen news isn't 100% official yet, but it seems like it's trending in that direction. We still got to be able to clear up a few things, so we'll see what ends up happening here. But the Greg Olsen news is still TBD, I'm being told. So something got leaked. I don't know if that leaked information is 100% accurate. A few of the guys on my team are like, wait a minute, let's not go with it. So that's still a little bit TBD. From my Batman says the whole thing, like, where'd you hear Olsen was fired? We heard from somebody. We're still now trying to go back to see if that source was 100% accurate. So we're still going to go through some other super chats. We got 805 Hunter says Olsen was horrible. Well, we'll see. We got Duncan 39. My Cowboys lost. Dak overrated. You're a Cowboys fan and you're super chatting here. Well, I appreciate you. I will say it was definitely a hard way to lose, but NFL officials, they've been really bad in the playoffs. Really curious to see what happens here for Monday Night Football. Akash Kumar, what do you think we can get for Carr? I said 2 first-round picks. If you can't get 2 first-round picks for Derek Carr, then, yeah, you might have to consider keeping him. Now, again, I will not extend DC. I will not pay DC over $30 million a year like I've heard that he's looking for. If he doesn't want to play on 19.9, no dead cap hit, then we're going to look to go other ways because as far as I'm concerned, he has not earned a contract extension. He has earned to play the final year of his deal. Let's go to Jarrett. Yeah. Jacqueline Davidson or Malik Boyd, GM candidates. The first one is with Tampa Bay. Boyd works with the Buffalo Bills. We need to get from winning teams. Now, I'll say this. The fact that Mayock was let go, spoiler alert, I'm going to be live tomorrow on the Raiders Report, 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific. One of the segments that you will see tomorrow is Mike Mayock replacements. I'm going to be breaking down probably the top 10. I'll probably also give you guys a whole bunch of other names that the Raiders could potentially look at to be the next general manager of the Las Vegas Raiders. So I got to do a lot of homework tonight. I haven't done too much digging into some of these candidates. Basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go home. You ever watch one of those murder mystery shows where they start taking the red lines, they put stuff up on the wall, they connect dots? That's what I'm going to do tonight. I'm going to put a lot of homework together. I'm going to start talking to some people, and that way I can put together a good list of some potential GM candidates. We got a super chat coming in from Scoob. Who you got for trade candidates on the Raiders roster? I got Cleveland Furl or maybe Littleton as Devine starts to step up. The issue is this. Nobody's going to pick up Cleveland Furl's almost $10 million, so Klee will not get traded. He has a better chance of getting cut. We eat the dead cap than him getting traded. And then same with Corey Littleton. The fact that the Raiders pushed back their contract as much as they did, I believe Littleton's dead cap hit this year is like $19 million. There's not a sane NFL team in the world that's going to pay Corey Littleton $19.9 million. All right, y'all, Mike Mayock is no longer the general manager of the Las Vegas Raiders. And if you guys want to go ahead, if you're excited about the news, you can like the video if you like it. If you don't like the move, then please, I want you to vent your frustrations down below. Also, shout out to DVO35. If the Raiders hire a new head coach with players, will request to be released slash traded because they don't want to be a part of the rebuild. I mean, you might see some of that, but here's the other issue that a lot of players are going to face. The amount of teams, the amount of players that signed one-year contracts this past year because salary cap was going up, this is going to be an offseason that's going to have a lot of moving parts, a lot of stuff changing. Russell Wilson going to be on the move. Aaron Rodgers going to be on the move. Like, there's going to be a lot of moving parts, and if teams want to go ahead and have that mentality, I don't think it's going to sit well with a lot of other people out there. Now, we went live here because Mike Mayock was fired today by the Las Vegas Raiders. I'm going to be live tomorrow at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific, so make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you turn on those notifications. Enjoy the rest of your Monday, and if you want to let me know who you got in tonight's game, you can type LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. One more super chat coming in from Gregory Vasquez. Is it true Olsen was fired? At this time, it's not true. Though, where there's smoke, there is fire, so please keep that in mind. And I say, go for Davante Adams no matter what. I am all on board for Davante Adams, but it's going to take a lot of money. I'm probably going to say 25 mil. Enjoy the rest of your day. Let me know what you guys are thinking about Mayock. Let me know who you got tonight. LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. And if you haven't subscribed yet, click that big red button that says subscribe. This is why you subscribe to the Raiders Report. Why? Because we come at you breaking news on a Monday. The Las Vegas Raiders have fired general manager Mike Mayock. Now, I promise you guys this all the time. News, rumors, 100% free. And even if it's my day off, I don't care. I'm giving you guys the content that you desire. So hit that sub button and turn on those notifications. That way you don't miss a thing. Now, the Raiders Report today is presented by a brand new sponsor that I am very, very excited to be able to talk about. Major shout out to Fetch Rewards. If anybody out there wants to go ahead and download this free app, all you got to do is go to chatsports.com/fetch. That's going to get you 3,000 bonus points. Now, for those of you wondering, well, why would I go ahead and download this? Has anybody ever bought anything? Has the cashier ever said, hey, do you want a receipt? Answer yes to that, and then you basically submit your receipts on this app where you can then get extra points, then get extra gift cards from places like Amazon, CVS. It's an awesome app. That link's going to be available for you on the comments and in the description. So the Las Vegas Raiders decided to move on from Mike Mayock after three seasons. Now the new search is going to go ahead and begin. We're going to talk about some guys that they've already requested to interview at general manager. We're also going to be breaking down some of the people that they've requested to interview as a potential head coach. Now the news broke on Monday, and I always like to say, and I say it all the time here, where there's smoke, there's probably going to end up being some fire. And a lot of smoke started happening on IG, on Twitter, all these places. And Ian Rapoport went ahead and tweeted, general manager Mike Mayock was informed that he won't be retained, sources said. John Gruden resigned in October. Mayock now out in January. Then Adam Schefter, he chimed in with his 2 cents as well. Unlike Mike Mayock, Raiders interim head coach Rich Bisaccia remains with the team at this time, but Las Vegas has submitted interview requests for at least one head coaching candidate. Now, yes, the one head coach candidate, which obviously we're going to get to here. They've also requested four other head coaching candidates, which they did probably about 2 months ago, maybe a month ago. But this is what the Raiders report's about. It's about giving you guys news, about giving you guys rumors, just about being diehard fans trying to collaborate together. So this is the opportunity where you guys can shine. I want you to go down in the comments section right now, and I want you to give me that one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. It can be a positive comment. It can be a negative comment. Whatever you're feeling is that initial knee-jerk reaction. My one-word reaction when I heard this, I was kind of like, buckle up. Not that I knew 100% that it was going to happen, but I started talking to some people, some of my friends in the industry. They were like, hey, I really truly believe that this is going to end up happening. So when I say buckle up, I mean it's going to be a very, very interesting next week or two. I mean, you could even look in 3 weeks, 4 weeks. The entire offseason is just going to be a time that I'm telling you, you're going to want to be subscribed here. You're going to be making sure that you have everything going on, because the next time that the Raiders announce who they're going to hire as a GM, I can guarantee you this, I'm going to be going live here on the Raiders Report. Now, I know I talked to you guys at the top of the show about Fetch, but I do want to say it one more time. Chuck loves this app. Chatsports.com/Fetch. It's free to download. You can kind of see how the app works here on the right side of me. You can take a picture of your receipt. You then upload it, and you can get rewarded for all of your shopping. So basically, let's just say you go ahead and you spend some money at a CVS. You scan that receipt. Then you can earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant. Like, guys, I'm telling you right now, super, super easy. So go to chatsports.com/fetch. Make sure you use promo code Raiders. Can you remember that? I know. It's right here on my sweatshirt. Promo code Raiders at chatsports.com/fetch to get 3,000 bonus points. So earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant, and then redeem those points for gift cards and other awesome rewards. Now, when you talk about Mike Mayock, everyone likes to say, all right, this guy was supposed to be, you know, I don't know, this draft guru from top to bottom, he could help us out. But, I mean, let's face it. These first-round picks, not so good. In fact, at times they almost take my breath away. Cleveland Furl, that's been an absolute bust. I love Josh Jacobs. He ran hell of a game this past week up against the Bengals. But running back's the easiest position to be able to replace. Jonathan Abram has absolutely not been worth a first-round pick, and he's going to be a guy that they say they're going to turn down his fifth-year option. Then in 2020, Henry Ruggs, trending in the right direction. Obviously, I can't really put that one against Mayock, but, you know, it is what it is now. Damon Arnett, if anybody watched more than 10 minutes of film on Arnett, and Mike Mayock said that they did more research than anybody, I foolishly would say, then you're crazy for honestly drafting Arnett in the first or second round. He's been a bust, and in fact, he was released by the Miami Dolphins today. And then Alex Leatherwood, another player that I had a round two grade on, thought they reached on him just a little bit, but when you add up the drafts, when you add up some of the trades that did not work, the big-time signings like a Trent Brown in free agency, the Antonio Brown trade, they've had a lot of things that simply, you have to realize, have not worked in Mike Mayock's favor. Now, in terms of some other general manager interview requests, they've had Dane Ziegler, who is director of player personnel of the New England Patriots, Ed Dodds, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. As this time, these are the only two general manager requests that the Raiders have put in. I said on my show on Sunday that the top guy that I want the Raiders to go out and at least put in 2 cents with is Lewis Riddick. I know Lewis Riddick would be interested in being a general manager in the National Football League. I think it's only a matter of time until you start seeing some news around him. But as it stands right now, the leading candidate for to be the next general manager of the Raiders is Ed Dodds, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. Now, if you don't like those two names there, I anticipate most people who are watching are probably going to go ahead and type LR for Lewis Riddick. I want to know, who should be the next Raiders general manager? If anybody wants to say my name, hey, I'll submit it. I'm totally down to do it. I'd be more than happy to try to get this team on the right track. So who should be the next Raiders general manager? Now, we are going to shift our ship here to the head coach because we're going to be talking about Rich Bisaccia a whole lot. And if anybody ever wants to hit me up with anything, remember, you can always hit me up on IG at MitchellRen365. And on top of that, I've been posting a lot more news, a lot more just rumblings and stuff that I'm hearing on my Twitter and IG. So please don't be afraid to give me a follow. Now, here's another tweet coming in here from Ian Rapoport that says, the Raiders have a top in-house candidate in DeJuan Daniels, assistant director of player personnel. Mark Davis still plans to interview interim Rich Bisaccia for the head job. Crazy the team made the playoffs despite Gruden resigning, Ruggs, injuries, and so much more. Which, you're 100% right. I mean, the Raiders are the first team in 60 years. Yes, first team in 60 years, basically the first team since Super Bowl era, to make the playoffs when another coach on that team was let go. Also, the Raiders are only the second team since the 2000 Alliance to win at least 9 games. I know the Raiders won 10, but at least 9 games. Like, that's how great Rich Bisaccia has been for this team. Now, in terms of some early head coach interviews, you have Bisaccia, Gus Bradley, Leslie Frazier, Todd Bowles. The four names that you see right here, these were announced probably, I'm going to say, about a month and a half ago. And then the new name that just popped up today on Monday was Jerod Mayo, inside linebacker of the New England Patriots. I could also see some extra names like, I think if you don't interview Brian Daboll, Kellen Moore, even extra names like a Byron Leftwich, if Mike Tomlin's available, Sean Payton, if he becomes available. I mean, there's going to be a lot of big names out there to potentially look at to be that next Raiders head coach. The issue is this, and not even an issue. If you were to ask me, Mitch, what's your gut feeling? And I'm feeling my gut right now, and it's who's going to be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. I've talked to very reliable sources, people even like James Yoder, who's very well connected with the Michigan Wolverines, and he said Jim Harbaugh right now is eyeing the Las Vegas Raiders. He also said that he's eyeing the Giants, but I've heard from multiple people that Jim Harbaugh could end up being absolutely the next head coach of the Raiders. And then you go out and you look at the Vegas odds. You look at all these other odds out there, and Harbaugh is the betting favorite to be the Raiders' next head coach. Now, there was a rumor circulating about a week and a half ago, 2 weeks, that the Raiders could potentially offer him $12 million. This also was kind of piggybacking off of another report that said that Harbaugh's gone silent in the Michigan football room, that, you know, apparently he didn't show up to a meeting in terms of discussing his long-term contract. I've been saying it for weeks. I've been turning my page on the fact that, hey, I actually wouldn't mind Jim Harbaugh. Now, this is a pretty interesting tweet. For those of you, I know, for those of you that don't know who Jumbo Elliott is, he was an old teammate of Harbaugh for like 14 seasons. Little birdie says Coach Harbaugh eyeing the Raiders and the Giants. All I'm saying is this, for an old friend, a good friend of Harbaugh, and an old teammate of his, all I got to say is for him to be tweeting out stuff like this, to me means that it's, you know, pretty well that he knows somebody, and the guy that he knows is Harbaugh. So, Elliott was a four-year teammate of Harbaugh at Michigan from 1983 to 86, two-time All-American, a 14-year NFL player with the Giants and Jets, and a 1993 Pro Bowler. He's very well connected, and he wouldn't just throw out a tweet like this if he didn't actually know. Now, if you were to ask me right now, who is the top head coach candidate for the Raiders, the most likely is Jim Harbaugh. He has had success wherever he has gone, which not a lot of coaches can say. When you look at the job that Harbaugh was able to do in San Diego, yeah, it was actually his first head coaching gig. He turned San Diego into a winning team, where they went 11-1, 11-1 the final 2 years. He took Stanford, that program, to a winning record. He took the Michigan Wolverines of late. They just took down Ohio State. He did it with San Francisco. They were 44-19-1 overall. If you were to ask me who is the front runner to be the next Raiders head coach, it is Jim Harbaugh. But I also will go ahead and say this. I want Rich Bisaccia back in that locker room. I want Rich Bisaccia back at Allegiant Stadium. I tweeted out at MitchellRens365 that Rich Bisaccia hand-wrote messages to every single Raiders player thanking them for basically just being dedicated to the game. I'm not sitting here saying that I want Bisaccia back as the head coach because, to be honest, I don't. but I would want Bisaccia back as the special teams coordinator, as your assistant head coach, and to reward him for really being a glue guy. I mean, when you hear people like Max Crosby, Derek Carr speak as highly as they do about Bisaccia, that goes a long way with me. So keep Bisaccia, give him extra money, make him that assistant head coach, and let's not go down a rabbit hole where you make one guy just the be-all in terms of a head coach. This is, needs to be a collective unit. Now, I appreciate everyone that's made it this far in the video. I know you're probably going to get ready for some Monday Night Football. Maybe you're going to go out and buy some food. If you buy some food, if you get a receipt, make sure you scan that. Free to download this app, chatsports.com/fetch. Just make sure you use promo code Raiders. That way you get some extra bonus points. That way you get some extra cards to go ahead and spend elsewhere. All right, y'all, go ahead. Shout out your city. Let me know where you're at. I don't know if you guys could tell, I had the worst tickle in the back of my throat, which is also top 10 weirdest things I've ever said on this show. If anybody knows what can help with a tickle in the back of my throat, please, can't wait to see what you have to say. Let me know where you guys are watching from. Shout out your city. We're going to go ahead now, and we're going to be answering some super chats, answering some questions. We've had a lot of stuff come up here on the show, and basically the more supers that come in, the more questions that we get. It's just the longer that I could stay live here on the show. I mean, like I said, today was my off day. Shout out to my team. Shout out to Harrison Graham, Chase Sr., Jeffrey Kubestein, Brett Scott, James Yoder, Tom Downey, Jeremy Biedling, Sam Brown. We got a hell of a team. Matthew Peterson. I'm trying to think. Did I forget anyone? I don't know. But they put this entire show together. I was able to walk in today on my off day, and they were able to set it up. So major shout out to all of them. Now let's go. Shout out your city. What do we got here? What is that? Mill Petisa, California from Richard. I don't know where that is. Madera, California. Santa Monica, California from Eric. Richmond, Virginia. Derek from Erica Salazar. Laren Moss says, teamwork. Landsberg, New York. Freeland, PA. B-I-L-O-X-I. I have no... Biloxi? Biloxi. I don't know, Mississippi. We have more coming in here. Let me know where you guys are watching from, and if you want to get a shout-out here on the show. We got Southgate. We got a North Carolina coming in from Tyler the Blaze, San Jose, California, Henderson, Nevada, Salinas, California, Utah from Raider B-Dog, Porterville, California, Hartford, Vegas, baby. So keep on coming in. Shout out your city. Let me know down in the comment section. And coming up right now, we're going to do a fun little like mailbag reaction to all the Mike Mayock news. So if you want to get featured on the show, the two ways to do it, hashtag Raiders, or you can go ahead and super chat. Once Brett gives me the thumbs up, we're going to go ahead. We're going to be answering all y'all's questions for the next maybe like 15 minutes or so. And then if the questions are good, if you guys are having a good time, which by the way, if you are having a good time right now, you're happy that we went live on the Raiders Report, please go ahead, like the video. Believe it or not, it does help us out a lot here. We are a free channel, and we do our best to be able to go ahead, keep you guys up to date on anything going on around the silver and black. So hashtag Raiders or Super Chat to get featured in this mailbag. Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report. The Las Vegas Raiders, they have moved on from general manager Mike Mayock. So what we're doing here on today's show is we're gonna react to it. This is a live instant reaction to Mike Mayock being fired from Raider Nation. So all the questions, all your comments is a knee-jerk reaction. So get ready. It's about to get wild. This first one's coming in from David Taken. I think the Raiders should re-sign Solomon Thomas, Denzel Perriman, Casey Hayward. Hire Harbaugh, fire Olsen. All right, so Solomon Thomas, I would want him back to on a much cheaper contract. Denzel Perriman's not a free agent. He's still got 1 year left on his deal. Casey Hayward's probably one of your top priorities. Yes, I like Harbaugh. Olsen's gone. Get rid of Parker. Brandon, he can still at least be a good depth piece. All right, let's go to Jeff. Derek Carr looks like a Lyle Zotto with the long hair. Yeah, he definitely needs to cut. He looks like the bad guy in all the Home Alone movies. Let's go to Zachary Rosfeld. I'm going to miss Leah Mayock the most. Yeah, she just tweeted out that it's official, and I don't know. I'm going to be honest. I'm not really going to miss her all that much. I'm going to miss her dad a lot more. He was a hardworking guy. I have a lot of respect for Mike, but I know what you're trying to do with this. I'm not going to get into a trap. I think Alex is watching home with Chuck, and that's just it's a nightmare. Let's go to Ben Sandoval. Wikipedia says that Lewis Riddick is the new GM. What's up? Believe it or not, I don't know if anybody has ever heard this, but you can actually just go on Wikipedia and you can change it. I could actually be the 47th president of the United States if I got credit. Now, sure, they can change it in 5 minutes, but shout out to the people that did that. And yeah, I would love to have Lewis Riddick as the next GM. Let's go to Alex Thompson. If Mitch, I did the bet US Raiders 125 for the jersey, made my bet, got the email. Yeah, you just got to be a little bit more patient. We get hundreds and hundreds of emails. So if anybody out there hasn't already gotten the jersey hookup, chatsports.com/Raiders, promo code Raiders125 for that 125% deposit bonus. Alex, my team, we scrub through a whole bunch of emails. So just be patient, my man. If you haven't noticed, I post all the time a guy's getting their free jersey. So I promise you, you will end up getting it. I just need you to be, you know, just as long as you follow the instructions, you know, we're going to be good. That's really what it comes down to. If you went to chatsports.com/Raiders, if you use promo code Raiders125, if you got that bet in before the Raiders and Bengals game, you're good. Nothing to worry about. If you didn't do that, then that can get us down a little bit of a rabbit hole because then I don't get credit, which means then I can't get a free jersey for y'all. So that's basically just how it works. All right, y'all, so let it out. What is your one-word reaction to Mike Mayock being fired? My one-word reaction was buckle up. Because I knew, like, there's going to be a lot of crazy stuff that ends up happening here for the Las Vegas Raiders probably over the next day or two, probably over the next week. There's going to be a lot of stuff going down. So if you haven't yet, let me know down in the comment section your one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. All right, y'all, we're going to start giving some shout-outs here to some of the Super Chats that have come in. I got Celestial Leon says, if Jim Harbaugh becomes the new head coach for the Raiders, what do we got? I actually think that Harbaugh absolutely could be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. Next GM, Thomas Dimitroff. Maybe Daniel, I'm not 100% sure. We got Ryan Decker. Who do you think the Raiders select with the first pick? Still way. You got to see what happens in free agency. You got to see what happens with Derek Carr. But we're going to be making a lot of videos about all that stuff. Appreciate you, Ryan. Jonathan Perez, I know this is not on topic, but unless DC is willing to run the ball and do whatever it takes to win, he's got to go. My vote. My vote is this. If DC is willing to stay on 19.9, I am willing to give him another shot. If not, and he wants a contract extension, trade him for at least 2 first-round picks. And if you can't get 2 first-round picks, then there's a whole other issue. But I am not extending Derek Carr. Let's go to Adam. Is Davis making these decisions on his own? I don't have a good answer. I haven't talked to Mark Davis, but it does sound like he's doing a lot of stuff. Jonathan Perez, appreciate it. Demokes, bruh, make polling bum moves. Really going after Patriots people. That's something I expect from the Lions organization. I can understand that a little bit, but we'll see what ends up happening. Let's go to Ben Jenkins. If Devin White was picked instead of Ferrell, Mike would still had his job. I actually don't know if that's even 100% sure. The Cleveland Ferrell one was really bad. Do I just say it out loud? Just go with it? The Olsen? All right, sounds good. Ben Jenkins, appreciate it. I see another people also that are typing in their Super Chats. If I don't get to them, please just hit me up on IG or on Twitter, MitchellRants365, because they are really coming in. Peter Silva, I think we should trade Carr if he can somehow sign Rodgers. I mean, if there's some way you can get an upgrade at QB, like that's what you got to do. If you can get Watson, if you can get Wilson, if you can get Rodgers, yeah, I'm kind of on board for it. Demokes, this is the one I was kind of reading before. Same owner who fired a coach who took us 12-4 one year out. I get what Mark Davis is doing. I will say this. I've said for a long time, I know Al was one of the greatest ever, if not the greatest owner in all of the NFL. Like, you can really put that into the equation. Mark, though, needs people to have somewhere around him because he has really struggled making critical decisions. Now, to Mokes, I appreciate it. All right, y'all, Mike Mayock is no longer the general manager of the Las Vegas Raiders. And if you guys want to go ahead, if you're excited about the news, you can like the video if you like it. If you don't like the move, then please, I want you to vent your frustrations down below. Also, shout out to DVL35. If the Raiders hire a new head coach with players, will request to be released slash traded because they don't want to be a part of the rebuild. I mean, you might see some of that, but here's the other issue that a lot of players are going to face. The amount of teams, the amount of players that signed one-year contracts this past year because salary cap was going up, this is going to be an offseason that's going to have a lot of moving parts, a lot of stuff changing. Russell Wilson going to be on the move. Aaron Rodgers is going to be on the move. Like, there's going to be a lot of moving parts, and if teams want to go ahead and have that mentality, I don't think it's going to sit well with a lot of other people out there. Now, we went live here because Mike Mayock was fired today by the Las Vegas Raiders. I'm going to be live tomorrow at 6 p.m. Eastern Time. 3 p.m. Pacific. So make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you turn on those notifications. Enjoy the rest of your Monday. And if you want to let me know who you got in tonight's game, you can type LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. One more super chat coming in from Gregory Vasquez. Is it true Olsen was fired? At this time, it's not true. Though, where there's smoke, there is fire, so please keep that in mind. And I say, go for Devontae Adams no matter what. I am all on board for Devontae Adams, but it's going to take a lot of money. I'm probably going to say 25 mil. Enjoy the rest of your day. Let me know what you guys are thinking about Mayock. Let me know who you got tonight. LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. And if you haven't subscribed yet, click that big red button. This is why you subscribe to the Raiders Report. Why? Because we come at you breaking news on a Monday. The Las Vegas Raiders have fired general manager Mike Mayock. Now, I promise you guys this all the time. News, rumors, 100% free. And even if it's my day off, I don't care. I'm giving you guys the content that you desire. So hit that sub button and turn on those notifications. That way you don't miss a thing. Now, the Raiders Report today is presented by a brand new sponsor that I am very, very excited to be able to talk about. Major shout out to Fetch Rewards. If anybody out there wants to go ahead and download this free app, all you got to do is go to chatsports.com/fetch. That's going to get you 3,000 bonus points. Now, for those of you wondering, well, why would I go ahead and download this? Has anybody ever bought anything? Has the cashier ever said, hey, do you want a receipt? Answer yes to that, and then you basically submit your receipts on this app where you can then get extra points, then get extra gift cards from places like Amazon, CVS. It's an awesome app. That link's going to be available for you on the comments and in the description. So the Las Vegas Raiders decided to move on from Mike Mayock after three seasons. Now the new search is going to go ahead and begin. We're going to talk about some guys that they've already requested to interview at general manager. We're also going to be breaking down some of the people that they've requested to interview as a potential head coach. Now the news broke on Monday, and I always like to say, and I say it all the time here, where there's smoke, there's probably going to end up being some fire. And a lot of smoke started happening on IG, on Twitter, all these places. And Ian Rapoport went ahead and tweeted, general manager Mike Mayock was informed that he won't be retained, sources said. John Gruden resigned in October. Mayock now out in January. Then Adam Schefter, he chimed in with his two cents as well. Unlike Mike Mayock, Raiders interim head coach Rich Bisaccia remains with the team at this time, but Las Vegas has submitted interview requests for at least one head coaching candidate. Now, yes, the one head coach candidate, which obviously we're going to get to here. They've also requested four other head coaching candidates, which they did probably about 2 months ago, maybe a month ago. But this is what the Raiders Report's about. It's about giving you guys news, about giving you guys rumors. It's just about being diehard fans trying to collaborate together. So this is the opportunity where you guys can shine. I want you to go down in the comments section right now, and I want you to give me that one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. It can be a positive comment. It can be a negative comment. Whatever you're feeling is that initial knee-jerk reaction. My one-word reaction when I heard this, I was kind of like, buckle up. Not that I knew 100% that it was going to happen, but I started talking to some people, some of my friends in the industry. They were like, hey, I really truly believe that this is going to end up happening. So when I say buckle up, I mean it's going to be a very, very interesting next week or two. I mean, you could even look in 3 weeks, 4 weeks. The entire offseason is just going to be a time that I'm telling you, you're going to want to be subscribed here. You're going to be making sure that you have everything going on, because the next time that the Raiders announce who they're going to hire as a GM, I guarantee you this, I'm going to be going live here on the Raiders Report. Now, I know I talked to you guys at the top of the show about Fetch, but I do want to say it one more time. Chuck loves this app. Chatsports.com/fetch. It's free to download. You can kind of see how the app works here on the right side of me. You can take a picture of your receipt. You then upload it, and you can get rewarded for all of your shopping. So basically, let's just say you go ahead and you spend some money at a CVS. You scan that receipt. Then you can earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant. Like, guys, I'm telling you right now, super, super easy. So go to chatsports.com/fetch. Make sure you use promo code Raiders. Can you remember that? I know. It's right here on my sweatshirt. Promo code Raiders at chatsports.com/fetch to get 3,000 bonus points. So earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant, and then redeem those points for gift cards and other awesome rewards. Now, when you talk about Mike Mayock, everyone likes to say, all right, this guy was supposed to be, you know, I don't know, this draft guru from top to bottom, he could help us out. But, I mean, let's face it. These first-round picks, not so good. In fact, At times, they almost take my breath away. Cleveland Furrell, that's been an absolute bust. I love Josh Jacobs. He ran hell of a game this past week up against the Bengals, but running back's the easiest position to be able to replace. Jonathan Abram has absolutely not been worth a first-round pick, and he's going to be a guy that they say they're going to turn down his fifth-year option. Then in 2020, Henry Ruggs trending in the right direction. Obviously, I can't really put that one against Mayock, but, you know, it is what it is now. Damon Arnett, if anybody watched more than 10 minutes of film on Arnett, and Mike Mayock said that they did more research than anybody, I foolishly would say then you're crazy for honestly drafting Arnett in the first or second round. He's been a bust, and in fact, he was released by the Miami Dolphins today. And then Alex Leatherwood, another player that I had a round two grade on, thought they reached on him just a little bit, but when you add up the draft and you add up some of the trades that did not work, the big-time signings like a Trent Brown in free agency, the Antonio Brown trade, they've had a lot of things that simply, you have to realize, have not worked in Mike Mayock's favor. Now, in terms of some other general manager interview requests, they've had Dane Ziegler, who is director of player personnel of the New England Patriots, Ed Dodds, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. As this time, these are the only two general manager requests that the Raiders have put in. I said on my show on Sunday that the top guy that I want the Raiders to go out and at least put in 2 cents with is Lewis Riddick. I know Lewis Riddick would be interested in being a general manager in the National Football League. I think it's only a matter of time until you start seeing some news around him. But as it stands right now, the leading candidate to be the next general manager of the Raiders is Ed Dodd, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. Now, if you don't like those two names there, I anticipate most people who are watching are probably going to go ahead and type LR for Lewis Riddick. I want to know, who should be the next Raiders general manager? If anybody wants to say my name, hey, I'll submit it. I'm totally down to do it. I'd be more than happy to try to get this team on the right track. So who should be the next Raiders general manager? Now, we are going to shift our ship here to the head coach because we're going to be talking about Rich Bisaccia a whole lot. And if anybody ever wants to hit me up with anything, remember, you can always hit me up on IG at MitchellRen365. And on top of that, I've been posting a lot more news, a lot more just rumblings and stuff that I'm hearing on my Twitter and IG. So please don't be afraid to give me a follow. Now, here's another tweet coming in here from Ian Rapoport that says, the Raiders have a top in-house candidate in DeJuan Daniels, assistant director of player personnel. Mark Davis still plans to interview interim Rich Bisaccia for the head job. Crazy the team made the playoffs despite Gruden resigning, Ruggs, injuries, and so much more. Which, you're 100% right. I mean, the Raiders are the first team in 60 years. Yes, first team in 60 years, basically the first team since Super Bowl era, to make the playoffs when another coach on that team was let go. Also, the Raiders are only the second team since the 2000 Alliance to win at least 9 games. I know the Raiders won 10, but at least 9 games. Like, that's how great Rich Bisaccia has been for this team. Now, in terms of some early head coach interviews, you have Bisaccia, Gus Bradley, Leslie Frazier, Todd Bowles. The four names that you see right here, these were announced probably, I'm going to say, about a month and a half ago. And then the new name that just popped up today on Monday was Jerod Mayo, inside linebacker of the New England Patriots. I could also see some extra names like, I think if you don't interview Brian Daboll, Kellen Moore, even extra names like Byron Leftwich, if Mike Tomlin's available, Sean Payton, if he becomes available. I mean, there's going to be a lot of big names out there to potentially look at to be that next Raiders head coach. The issue is this, and not even an issue. If you were to ask me, Mitch, what's your gut feeling? And I'm feeling my gut right now, and it's who's going to be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. I've talked to very reliable sources, people even like James Yoder, who's very well connected with the Michigan Wolverines, and he said Jim Harbaugh right now is eyeing the Las Vegas Raiders. He also said that he's eyeing the Giants, but I've heard from multiple people that Jim Harbaugh could end up being absolutely the next head coach of the Raiders. And then you go out and you look at the Vegas odds, you look at all these other odds out there, and Harbaugh is the betting favorite to be the Raiders' next head coach. Now, there was a rumor circulating about a week and a half ago, 2 weeks, that the Raiders could potentially offer him $12 million. This also was kind of piggybacking off of another report that said that Harbaugh's gone silent in the Michigan football room, that, you know, apparently he didn't show up to a meeting in terms of discussing his long-term contract. I've been saying it for weeks. I've been turning my page on the fact that, hey, I actually wouldn't mind Jim Harbaugh. Now, this is a pretty interesting tweet. For those of you, I know, for those of you that don't know who Jumbo Elliott is, he was an old teammate of Harbaugh for like 14 seasons. Little Birdie says Coach Harbaugh eyeing the Raiders and the Giants. All I'm saying is this, for an old friend, a good friend of Harbaugh, and an old teammate of his, all I got to say is for him to be tweeting out stuff like this, to me means that it's, you know, pretty well that he knows somebody, and the guy that he knows is Harbaugh. So, Elliot was a four-year teammate of Harbaugh at Michigan from 1983 to 86, two-time All-American, and 14-year NFL player with the Giants and Jets, and a 1993 Pro Bowl. He's very well connected, and he wouldn't just throw out a tweet like this if he didn't actually know. Now, if you were to ask me right now, who is the top head coach candidate for the Raiders, the most likely is Jim Harbaugh. He has had success wherever he has gone, which not a lot of coaches can say. When you look at the job that Harbaugh was able to do in San Diego, yeah, it was actually his first head coaching gig. He turned San Diego into a winning team, where they went 11-1, 11-1 the final 2 years. He took Stanford, that program, to a winning record. He took the Michigan Wolverines of late. They just took down Ohio State. He did it with San Francisco. They were 44-19-1 overall. If you were to ask me who is the front runner to be the next Raiders head coach, it is Jim Harbaugh. But I also will go ahead and say this. I want Rich Bisaccia back in that locker room. I want Rich Bisaccia back at Allegiant Stadium. I tweeted out at MitchellRens365 that Rich Bisaccia hand wrote messages to every single Raiders player thanking them for basically just being dedicated to the game. I'm not sitting here saying that I want Bisaccia back as the head coach, because to be honest, I don't. But I would want Bisaccia back as the special teams coordinator, as your assistant head coach, and to reward him for really being a glue guy. I mean, when you hear people like Max Crosby, Derek Carr speak as highly as they do about Bisaccia, that goes a long way with me. So keep Bisaccia, give him extra money, make him that assistant head coach, and let's not go down a rabbit hole where you make one guy just the be-all in terms of a head coach. This is needs to be a collective unit. Now, I appreciate everyone that's made it this far in the video. I know you're probably going to get ready for some Monday Night Football. Maybe you're going to go out and buy some food. If you buy some food, if you get a receipt, make sure you scan that. Free to download this app, chatsports.com/fetch. Just make sure you use promo code Raiders. That way you get some extra bonus points. That way you get some extra cards to go ahead and spend elsewhere. All right, y'all, go ahead. Shout out your city. Let me know where you're at. I don't know if you guys could tell, I had the worst tickle in the back of my throat, which is also top 10 weirdest things I've ever said on this show. If anybody knows what can help with a tickle in the back of my throat, please, can't wait to see what you have to say. Let me know where you guys are watching from. Shout out your city. We're going to go ahead now, and we're going to be answering some super chats, answering some questions. We've had a lot of stuff come up here on the show, and basically the more supers that come in, the more questions that we get, it's just the longer that I could stay live here on the show. I mean, like I said, today was my off day. Shout out to my team. Shout out to Harrison Graham, Chase Sr., Jeffrey Kubestein, Brett Scott, James Yoder, Tom Downey, Jeremy Biedling, Sam Brown. We got a hell of a team. Matthew Peterson. Trying to think, did I forget anyone? I don't know. But they put this entire show together. I was able to walk in today on my off day, and they were able to set it up. So major shout out to all of them. Now let's go. Shout out your city. What do we got here? What is that? Mill Petisa, California from Richard. I don't know where that is. Madera, California. Santa Monica, California from Eric. Richmond, Virginia. Derek from Erica Salazar. Laren Moss says teamwork. Landsberg, New York. Freeland, PA. B-I-L-O-X-I. I have no Biloxi? Biloxi. I don't know, Mississippi. We have more coming in here. Let me know where you guys are watching from, and if you want to get a shout-out here on the show. We got Southgate. We got a North Carolina coming in from Tyler the Blaze. San Jose, California. Henderson, Nevada. Salinas, California. Utah from Raider B-Dog. Porterville, California. Hartford. Vegas, baby. So keep on coming in. Shout out your city. Let me know down in the comment section. Coming up right now, we're going to do a fun little like mailbag reaction to all the Mike Mayock news. So if you want to get featured on the show, the two ways to do it, hashtag Raiders, or you can go ahead and super chat. Once Brett gives me the thumbs up, we're going to go ahead. We're going to be answering all y'all's questions for the next maybe like 15 minutes or so. And then if the questions are good, if you guys are having a good time, which by the way, if you are having a good time right now, you're happy that we went live on the Raiders Report, please go ahead, like the video. Believe it or not, it does help us out a lot here. We are a free channel, and we do our best to be able to go ahead, keep you guys up to date on anything going on around the silver and black. So hashtag Raiders or Super Chat to get featured in this mailbag. Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report. The Las Vegas Raiders, they have moved on from general manager Mike Mayock. So what we're doing here on today's show is we're gonna react to it. This is a live instant reaction to Mike Mayock being fired from Raider Nation. So all the questions, all your comments is a knee-jerk reaction. So get ready. It's about to get wild. This first one's coming in from David Taken. I think the Raiders should re-sign Solomon Thomas, Denzel Perriman, Casey Hayward, hire Harbaugh, fire Olsen. All right, so Solomon Thomas, I would want him back to on a much cheaper contract. Denzel Perriman's not a free agent. He's still got 1 year left on his deal. Casey Hayward's probably one of your top priorities. Yes, I like Harbaugh. Olsen's gone. Get rid of Parker. Brandon, he can still at least be a good depth piece. All right, let's go to Jeff. Derek Carr looks like a Lyle Zotto with the long hair. Yeah, he definitely needs to cut. He looks like the bad guy in all the Home Alone movies. Let's go to Zachary Rossfeld. I'm going to miss Leah Mayock the most. Yeah, she just tweeted out that it's official, and I don't know. I'm going to be honest. I'm not really going to miss her all that much. I'm going to miss her dad a lot more. He was a hardworking guy. I have a lot of respect for Mike, but I know what you're trying to do with this. I'm not going to get into a trap. I think Alex is watching home with Chuck, and that's just it's a nightmare. Let's go to Ben Sandoval. Wikipedia says that Lewis Riddick is the new GM. What's up? Believe it or not, I don't know if anybody has ever heard this, but you can actually just go on Wikipedia and you can change it. I could actually be the 47th president of the United States if I got credit. Now, sure, they can change it in 5 minutes, but shout out to the people that did that. And yeah, I would love to have Lewis Riddick as the next GM. Let's go to Alex Thompson. If Mitch, I did the bet US Raiders 125 for the jersey, made my bet, got the email. Yeah, you just got to be a little bit more patient. We get hundreds and hundreds of emails. So if anybody out there hasn't already gotten the jersey hookup, chatsports.com/Raiders, promo code Raiders125 for that 125% deposit bonus. Alex, my team, we scrubbed through a whole bunch of emails. So just be patient, my man. If you haven't noticed, I post all the time of guys getting their free jersey. So I promise you, you will end up getting it. I just need you to be, you know, just as long as you follow the instructions, you know, we're going to be good. That's really what it comes down to. If you went to chatsports.com/Raiders, if you use promo code Raiders125, if you got that bet in before the Raiders and Bengals game, you're good. Nothing to worry about. If you didn't do that, then that can get us down a little bit of a rabbit hole because then I don't get credit, which means then I can't get a free jersey for y'all. So that's basically just how it works. All right, y'all, so let it out. What is your one-word reaction to Mike Mayock being fired? My one-word reaction was buckle up. Because I knew, like, there's going to be a lot of crazy stuff that ends up happening here for the Las Vegas Raiders probably over the next day or two, probably over the next week. There's going to be a lot of stuff going down. So if you haven't yet, let me know down in the comments section your one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. All right, y'all, we're going to start giving some shout-outs here to some of the super chats that have come in. I got Celestial Leon says, if Jim Harbaugh becomes the new head coach for the Raiders, what do we got? I actually think that Harbaugh absolutely could be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. Next GM, Thomas Dimitroff. Maybe Daniel, I'm not 100% sure. We got Ryan Decker. Who do you think the Raiders select with the first pick? Still way, way. You got to see what happens in free agency. You got to see what happens with Derek Carr. But we're going to be making a lot of videos about all that stuff. Appreciate you, Ryan. Jonathan Perez, I know this is not on topic, but unless DC is willing to run the ball and do whatever it takes to win, he's got to go. My vote. My vote is this. If DC is willing to stay on 19.9, I am willing to give him another shot. If not, and he wants a contract extension, trade him for at least 2 first-round picks. And if you can't get 2 first-round picks, then there's a whole other issue. But I am not extending Derek Carr. Let's go to Adam. Is Davis making these decisions on his own? I don't have a good answer. I haven't talked to Mark Davis, but it does sound like he's doing a lot of stuff. Jonathan Perez, appreciate it. Demokes, bruh, make polling bum moves. Really going after Patriots people. It's something I expect from the Lions organization. I can understand that a little bit, but we'll see what ends up happening. Let's go to Ben Jenkins. If Devin White was picked instead of Ferrell, Mike would still had his job. I actually don't know if that's even 100% sure. The Cleveland Ferrell one was really bad. Do I just say it out loud? Just go with it? The Olsen? All right, sounds good. Ben Jenkins, appreciate it. I see another people also that are typing in their super chats. If I don't get to them, please just hit me up on IG or on Twitter, MitchellRants365, because they are really coming in. Peter Silva, I think we should trade Carr if he can somehow sign Rodgers. I mean, if there's some way you can get, and upgrade a QB. Like, that's what you got to do. If you can get Watson, if you can get Wilson, if you can get Rodgers, yeah, I'm kind of on board for it. Demokes, this is the one I was kind of reading before. Same owner who fired a coach who took us 12-4 one year out. I get what Mark Davis is doing. I will say this. I've said for a long time, I know Al was one of the greatest ever, if not the greatest owner in all of the NFL. Like, you can really put that into the equation. Mark, though, needs people to have somewhere around him because he has really struggled making critical, critical decisions. Now, to Mokes, I appreciate it. All right, y'all, Mike Mayock is no longer the general manager of the Las Vegas Raiders. And if you guys want to go ahead, if you're excited about the news, you can like the video if you like it. If you don't like the move, then please, I want you to vent your frustrations down below. Also, shout out to DVO35. If the Raiders hire a new head coach with players, will request to be released slash traded because they don't want to be a part of the rebuild. I mean, you might see some of that, but here's the other issue that a lot of players are going to face. The amount of teams, the amount of players that signed one-year contracts this past year because salary cap was going up, this is going to be an offseason that's going to have a lot of moving parts, a lot of stuff changing. Russell Wilson going to be on the move. Aaron Rodgers going to be on the move. Like, there's going to be a lot of moving parts, and if teams want to go ahead and have that mentality, I don't think it's going to sit well with a lot of other people out there. Now, we went live here because Mike Mayock was fired today by the Las Vegas Raiders. I'm going to be live tomorrow at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific, so make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you turn on those notifications. Enjoy the rest of your Monday, and if you want to let me know who you got in tonight's game, you can type LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. One more super chat coming in from Gregory Vasquez. Is it true Olsen was fired? At this time, it's not true. Though, where there's smoke, there is fire. So please keep that in mind. And I say, go for Devontae Adams no matter what. I am all on board for Devontae Adams, but it's going to take a lot of money. I'm probably going to say 25 mil. Enjoy the rest of your day. Let me know what you guys are thinking about Mayock. Let me know who you got tonight. LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. And if you haven't subscribed yet, click that big red button. This is why you subscribe to the Raiders Report. Why? Because we come at you breaking news on a Monday. The Las Vegas Raiders have fired general manager Mike Mayock. Now, I promise you guys this all the time. News, rumors, 100% free. And even if it's my day off, I don't care. I'm giving you guys the content that you desire. So hit that sub button and turn on those notifications. That way you don't miss a thing. Now, the Raiders Report today is presented by a brand new sponsor that I am very, very excited to be able to talk about. Major shout out to Fetch Rewards. If anybody out there wants to go ahead and download this free app, all you got to do is go to chatsports.com/fetch. That's going to get you 3,000 bonus points. Now, for those of you wondering, well, why would I go ahead and download this? Has anybody ever bought anything? Has the cashier ever said, hey, do you want a receipt? Answer yes to that, and then you basically submit your receipts on this app where you can then get extra points, then get extra gift cards from places like Amazon, CVS. It's an awesome app. That link's going to be available for you on the comments and in the description. So the Las Vegas Raiders decided to move on from Mike Mayock after three seasons. Now the new search is going to go ahead and begin. We're going to talk about some guys that they've already requested to interview at general manager. We're also going to be breaking down some of the people that they've requested to interview as a potential head coach. Now the news broke on Monday, and I always like to say, and I say it all the time here, where there's smoke, there's probably going to end up being some fire. And a lot of smoke started happening on IG, on Twitter, all these places. And Ian Rapoport went ahead and tweeted, general manager Mike Mayock was informed that he won't be retained, sources said. John Gruden resigned in October. Mayock now out in January. Then Adam Schefter, he chimed in with his two cents as well. Unlike Mike Mayock, Raiders interim head coach Rich Bisaccia remains with the team at this time, but Las Vegas has submitted interview requests for at least one head coaching candidate. Now, yes, the one head coach candidate, which obviously we're going to get to here. They've also requested four other head coaching candidates, which they did probably about 2 months ago, maybe a month ago. But this is what the Raiders Report's about. It's about giving you guys news, about giving you guys rumors. It's just about being diehard fans trying to collaborate together. So this is the opportunity where you guys can shine. I want you to go down in the comments section right now, and I want you to give me that one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. It can be a positive comment. It can be a negative comment. Whatever you're feeling is that initial knee-jerk reaction. My one-word reaction when I heard this, I was kind of like, buckle up. Not that I knew 100% that it was going to happen, but I started talking to some people, some of my friends in the industry. They were like, hey, I really truly believe that this is going to end up happening. So when I say buckle up, I mean it's going to be a very, very interesting next week or two. I mean, you could even look in 3 weeks, 4 weeks. The entire offseason is just going to be a time that I'm telling you, you're going to want to be subscribed here. You're going to be making sure that you have everything going on, because the next time that the Raiders announce who they're going to hire as a GM, I guarantee you this, I'm going to be going live here on the Raiders Report. Now, I know I talked to you guys at the top of the show about Fetch, but I do want to say it one more time. Chuck loves this app, chatsports.com/fetch. It's free to download. You can kind of see how the app works here on the right side of me. You can take a picture of your receipt. You then upload it, and you can get rewarded for all of your shopping. So basically, let's just say you go ahead and you spend some money at a CVS, you scan that receipt, then you can earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant. Like, guys, I'm telling you right now, super, super easy. So go to chatsports.com/fetch. Make sure you use promo code Raiders. Can you remember that? I know. It's right here on my sweatshirt. Promo code Raiders at chatsports.com/fetch to get 3,000 bonus points. So earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant, and then redeem those points for gift cards and other awesome rewards. Now, when you talk about Mike Mayock, everyone likes to say, all right, this guy was supposed to be, you know, I don't know, this draft guru from top to bottom. He could help us out. But, I mean, let's face it. These first-round picks, not so good. In fact, at times they almost take my breath away. Cleveland Furl, that's been an absolute bust. I love Josh Jacobs. He ran hell of a game this past week up against the Bengals. But running back's the easiest position to be able to replace. Jonathan Abram has absolutely not been worth a first-round pick, and he's going to be a guy that they say they're going to turn down his fifth-year option. Then in 2020, Henry Ruggs, trending in the right direction. Obviously, I can't really put that one against Mayock, but, you know, it is what it is now. Damon Arnett, if anybody watched more than 10 minutes of film on Arnett, and Mike Mayock said that they did more research than anybody, I foolishly would say then you're crazy for honestly drafting Arnett in the first or second round. He's been a bust, and in fact, he was released by the Miami Dolphins today. And then Alex Leatherwood, another player that I had a round two grade on, thought they reached on him just a little bit, but when you add up the drafts, when you add up some of the trades that did not work, the big-time signings like a Trent Brown in free agency, the Antonio Brown trade, they've had a lot of things that simply, you have to realize, have not worked in Mike Mayock's favor. Now, in terms of some other general manager interview requests, they've had Dane Ziegler, who is director of player personnel of the New England Patriots, Ed Dodds, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. As this time, these are the only two general manager requests that the Raiders have put in. I said on my show on Sunday that the top guy that I want the Raiders to go out and at least put in 2 cents with is Lewis Riddick. I know Lewis Riddick would be interested in being a general manager in the National Football League. I think it's only a matter of time until you start seeing some news around him. But as it stands right now, the leading candidate to be the next general manager of the Raiders is Ed Dodds, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. Now, if you don't like those two names there, I anticipate most people who are watching are probably going to go ahead and type LR for Lewis Riddick. I want to know, who should be the next Raiders general manager? If anybody wants to say my name, hey, I'll submit it. I'm totally down to do it. I'd be more than happy to try to get this team on the right track. So who should be the next Raiders general manager? Now, we are going to shift our ship here to the head coach, because we're going to be talking about Rich Bisaccia a whole lot. And if anybody ever wants to hit me up with anything, remember, you can always hit me up on IG at MitchellRen365. And on top of that, I've been posting a lot more news, a lot more just rumblings and stuff that I'm hearing on my Twitter and IG. So please don't be afraid to give me a follow. Now, here's another tweet coming in here from Ian Rapoport that says, the Raiders have a top in-house candidate in DeJuan Daniels, assistant director of player personnel. Mark Davis still plans to interview interim Rich Bisaccia for the head job. Crazy the team made the playoffs despite Gruden resigning, Ruggs, injuries, and so much more. Which, you're 100% right. I mean, the Raiders are the first team in 60 years. Yes, first team in 60 years, basically the first team since Super Bowl era, to make the playoffs when another coach on that team was let go. Also, the Raiders are only the second team since the 2000 Alliance to win at least 9 games. I know the Raiders won 10, but at least 9 games. Like, that's how great Rich Bisaccia has been for this team. Now, in terms of some early head coach interviews, you have Bisaccia, Gus Bradley, Leslie Frazier, Todd Bowles. The four names that you see right here, these were announced probably, I'm going to say, about a month and a half ago. And then the new name that just popped up today on Monday was Jerod Mayo, inside linebacker of the New England Patriots. I could also see some extra names like, I think if you don't interview Brian Daboll, Kellen Moore, even extra names like a Byron Leftwich, if Mike Tomlin's available, Sean Payton, if he becomes available. I mean, there's going to be a lot of big names out there to potentially look at to be that next Raiders head coach. The issue is this, and not even an issue. If you were to ask me, Mitch, what's your gut feeling? And I'm feeling my gut right now, and it's who's going to be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders? I've talked to very reliable sources, people even like James Yoder, who's very well connected with the Michigan Wolverines, and he said Jim Harbaugh right now is eyeing the Las Vegas Raiders. He also said that he's eyeing the Giants, but I've heard from multiple people that Jim Harbaugh could end up being absolutely the next head coach of the Raiders. And then you go out and you look at the Vegas odds, you look at all these other odds out there, and Harbaugh is the betting favorite to be the Raiders' next head coach. Now, there was a rumor circulating about a week and a half ago, 2 weeks, that the Raiders could potentially offer him $12 million. This also was kind of piggybacking off of another report that said that Harbaugh's gone silent in the Michigan football room, that, you know, apparently he didn't show up to a meeting in terms of discussing his long-term contract. I've been saying it for weeks. I've been turning my page on the fact that, hey, I actually wouldn't mind Jim Harbaugh. Now, this is a pretty interesting tweet. For those of you, I know, for those of you that don't know who Jumbo Elliott is, he was an old teammate of Harbaugh for like 14 seasons. Little Birdie says Coach Harbaugh eyeing the Raiders and the Giants. All I'm saying is this, for an old friend, a good friend of Harbaugh, and an old teammate of his, all I got to say is for him to be tweeting out stuff like this, to me means that it's, you know, pretty well that he knows somebody, and the guy that he knows is Harbaugh. So Elliott was a four-year teammate of Harbaugh at Michigan from 1983 to 86, two-time All-American, a 14-year NFL player with the Giants and Jets, and a 1993 Pro Bowler. He's very well connected, and he wouldn't just throw out a tweet like this if he didn't actually know. Now, if you were to ask me right now, who is the top head coach candidate for the Raiders, the most likely is Jim Harbaugh. He has had success wherever he has gone, which not a lot of coaches can say. When you look at the job that Harbaugh was able to do in San Diego, yeah, it was actually his first head coaching gig. He turned San Diego into a winning team, where they went 11-1, 11-1 the final 2 years. He took Stanford, that program, to a winning record. He took the Michigan Wolverines of late. They just took down Ohio State. He did it with San Francisco. They were 44-19-1 overall. If you were to ask me who is the front runner to be the next Raiders head coach, it is Jim Harbaugh. But I also will go ahead and say this. I want Rich Bisaccia back in that locker room. I want Rich Bisaccia back at Allegiant Stadium. I tweeted out at MitchellRenz365 that Rich Bisaccia hand wrote messages to every single Raiders player thanking them for basically just being dedicated to the game. I'm not sitting here saying that I want Bisaccia back as the head coach because, to be honest, I don't. But I would want Bisaccia back as the special teams coordinator, as your assistant head coach, and to reward him for really being a glue guy. I mean, when you hear people like Max Crosby, Derek Carr speak as highly as they do about Bisaccia, that goes a long way with me. So keep Bisaccia, give him extra money, make him that assistant head coach, and let's not go down a rabbit hole where you make one guy just the be-all in terms of a head coach. This needs to be a collective unit. Now, I appreciate everyone that's made it this far in the video. I know you're probably going to get ready for some Monday Night Football. Maybe you're going to go out and buy some food. If you buy some food, if you get a receipt, make sure you scan that. Free to download this app, chatsports.com/fetch. Just make sure you use promo code Raiders. That way you get some extra bonus points. That way you get some extra cards to go ahead and spend elsewhere. All right, y'all, go ahead. Shout out your city. Let me know where you're at. I don't know if you guys could tell, I had the worst tickle in the back of my throat, which is also top 10 weirdest things I've ever said on this show. If anybody knows what can help with a tickle in the back of my throat, please, can't wait to see what you have to say. Let me know where you guys are watching from. Shout out your city. We're going to go ahead now, and we're going to be answering some super chats, answering some questions. We've had a lot of stuff come up here on the show, and basically the more supers that come in, the more questions that we get, it's just the longer that I could stay live here on the show. I mean, like I said, today was my off day. Shout out to my team. Shout out to Harrison Graham, Chase Sr., Jeffrey Kubestein, Brett Scott, James Yoder, Tom Downey, Jeremy Biedling, Sam Brown. We got a hell of a team. Matthew Peterson. I'm trying to think. Did I forget anyone? I don't know. But they put this entire show together. I was able to walk in today on my off day, and they were able to set it up. So major shout out to all of them. Now let's go. Shout out your city. What do we got here? We got We have, what is that, Mill Petisa, California from Richard? I don't know where that is. Madera, California. Santa Monica, California from Eric. Richmond, Virginia. Derek from Erica Salazar. Laren Moss says, teamwork. Landsberg, New York. Freeland, PA. B-I-L-O-X-I. I have no, Biloxi? Biloxi. I don't know, Mississippi. We have more coming in here. Let me know where you guys are watching from. And if you want to get a shout-out here on the show, we got Southgate. We got a North Carolina coming in from Tyler the Blaze. San Jose, California. Henderson, Nevada. Salinas, California. Utah from Raider B-Dog. Porterville, California. Hartford. Vegas, baby. So keep on coming in. Shout out your city. Let me know down in the comment section. And coming up right now, we're going to do a fun little like mailbag reaction to all the Mike Mayock news. So if you want to get featured on the show, the two ways to do it, hashtag Raiders, or you can go ahead and super chat. Once Brett gives me the thumbs up, we're going to go ahead. We're going to be answering all y'all's questions for the next maybe like 15 minutes or so. And then if the questions are good, if you guys are having a good time, which, by the way, if you are having a good time right now, you're happy that we went live on the Raiders Report, please go ahead, like the video. Believe it or not, it does help us out a lot here. We are a free channel, and we do our best to be able to go ahead, keep you guys up to date on anything going on around the silver and black. So hashtag Raiders or Super Chat to get featured in this mailbag. Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report. The Las Vegas Raiders, they have moved on from general manager Mike Mayock. So what we're doing here on today's show is we're gonna react to it. This is a live instant reaction to Mike Mayock being fired from Raider Nation. So all the questions, all your comments is a knee-jerk reaction. So get ready. It's about to get wild. This first one's coming in from David Taken. I think the Raiders should re-sign Solomon Thomas, Denzel Perriman, Casey Hayward, hire Harbaugh, fire Olsen. All right, so Solomon Thomas, I would want him back though on a much cheaper contract. Denzel Perriman's not a free agent. He's still got 1 year left on his deal. Casey Hayward's probably one of your top priorities. Yes, I like Harbaugh. Olsen's gone. Get rid of Parker. Brandon, he can still at least be a good depth piece. All right, let's go to Jeff. Derek Carr looks like a Lyle Zotto with the long hair. Yeah, he definitely needs to cut. He looks like the bad guy in all the Home Alone movies. Let's go to Zachary Rossfeld. I'm going to miss Leah Mayock the most. Yeah, she just tweeted out that it's official, and I don't know. I'm going to be honest. I'm not really going to miss her all that much. I'm going to miss her dad a lot more. He was a hardworking guy. I have a lot of respect for Mike, but I know what you're trying to do with this. I'm not going to get into a trap. I think Alex is watching home with Chuck, and it's a nightmare. Let's go to Ben Sandoval. Wikipedia says that Lewis Riddick is the new GM. What's up? Believe it or not, I don't know if anybody has ever heard this, but you can actually just go on Wikipedia and you can change it. I could actually be the 47th president of the United States if I got credit. Now, sure, they can change it in 5 minutes, but shout out to the people that did that. And yeah, I would love to have Lewis Riddick as the next GM. Let's go to Alex Thompson. If Mitch, I did the bet US Raiders 125 for the jersey, made my bet, got the email. Yeah, you just got to be a little bit more patient. We get hundreds and hundreds of emails. So if anybody out there hasn't already gotten the jersey, hook up chatsports.com/Raiders, promo code Raiders125 for that 125% deposit bonus. Alex, my team, we scrub through a whole bunch of emails. So just be patient, my man. If you haven't noticed, I post all the time of guys getting their free jersey. So I promise you, you will end up getting it. I just need you to be, just – as long as you follow the instructions, we're going to be good. That's really what it comes down to. If you went to chatsports.com/Raiders, if you use promo code Raiders125, if you got that bet in before the Raiders and Bengals game, you're good. Nothing to worry about. If you didn't do that, then that can get us down a little bit of a rabbit hole because then I don't get credit, which means then I can't get a free jersey for y'all. So that's basically just how it works. All right, y'all, so let it out. What is your one-word reaction to Mike Mayock being fired? My one-word reaction was buckle up. Because I knew there's going to be a lot of crazy stuff that ends up happening here for the Las Vegas Raiders probably over the next day or two, probably over the next week. There's going to be a lot of stuff going down. So if you haven't yet, let me know down in the comments section your one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. All right, y'all, we're going to start giving some shout-outs here to some of the super chats that have come in. I got Celestial Leon says, if Jim Harbaugh becomes the new head coach for the Raiders, what do we got? I actually think that Harbaugh absolutely could be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. Next GM, Thomas Dimitroff. maybe Daniel. I'm not 100% sure. We got Ryan Decker. Who do you think the Raiders select with the first pick? Still way, way. You got to see what happens in free agency. You got to see what happens with Derek Carr. But we're going to be making a lot of videos about all that stuff. Appreciate you, Ryan. Jonathan Perez, I know this is not on topic, but unless DC is willing to run the ball and do whatever it takes to win, he's got to go. My vote. My vote is this. If DC is willing to stay on 19.9, I am willing to give him another shot. If not, and he wants a contract extension, trade him for at least two first-round picks. And if you can't get two first-round picks, then there's a whole other issue. But I am not extending Derek Carr. Let's go to Adam. Is Davis making these decisions on his own? I don't have a good answer. I haven't talked to Mark Davis, but it does sound like he's doing a lot of stuff. Jonathan Perez, appreciate it. Demokes, bruh, make polling bum moves. Really going after Patriots people. It's something I expect from the Lions organization. I can understand that a little bit, but we'll see what ends up happening. Let's go to Ben Jenkins. If Devin White was picked instead of Ferrell, Mike would still had his job. I actually don't know if that's even 100% sure. The Cleveland Ferrell one was really bad. Do I just say it out loud? Just go with it? The Olsen? All right, sounds good. Ben Jenkins, appreciate it. I see another people also that are typing in their super chats. If I don't get to them, please just hit me up on IG or on Twitter, MitchellRants365, because they are really coming in. Peter Silva, I think we should trade Carr if he can somehow sign Rodgers. I mean, if there's some way you can get an upgrade at QB, like that's what you got to do. If you can get Watson, if you get Wilson, if you can get Rodgers, yeah, I'm kind of on board for it. Demokes, this is the one I was kind of reading before. Same owner who fired a coach who took us 12-4 one year out. I get what Mark Davis is doing. I will say this. I've said for a long time, I know Al was one of the greatest ever, if not the greatest owner in all of the NFL. Like, you can really put that into the equation. Mark, though, needs people to have somewhere around him because he has really struggled making critical, critical decisions. Now, to Mokes, I appreciate it. All right, y'all, Mike Mayock is no longer the general manager of the Las Vegas Raiders. And if you guys want to go ahead, if you're excited about the news, you can like the video if you like it. If you don't like the move, then please, I want you to vent your frustrations down below. Also, shout out to DVL35. If the Raiders hire a new head coach with players, will request to be released slash traded because they don't want to be a part of the rebuild. I mean, you might see some of that, but here's the other issue that a lot of players are going to face. The amount of teams, the amount of players that signed one-year contracts this past year because salary cap was going up, this is going to be an offseason that's going to have a lot of moving parts, a lot of stuff changing. Russell Wilson going to be on the move. Aaron Rodgers going to be on the move. Like, there's going to be a lot of moving parts, and if teams want to go ahead and have that mentality, I don't think it's going to sit well with a lot of other people out there. Now, we went live here because Mike Mayock was fired today by the Las Vegas Raiders. I'm going to be live tomorrow at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific, so make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you turn on those notifications. Enjoy the rest of your Monday, and if you want to let me know who you got in tonight's game, you can type LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. One more super chat coming in from Gregory Vasquez. Is it true Olsen was fired? At this time, it's not true. Though, where there's smoke, there is fire, so please keep that in mind. And I say, go for Davante Adams no matter what. I am all on board for Davante Adams, but it's going to take a lot of money. I'm probably going to say 25 mil. Enjoy the rest of your day. Let me know what you guys are thinking about Mayock. Let me know who you got tonight. LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. And if you haven't subscribed yet, click that big red button. This is why you subscribe to the Raiders Report. Why? Because we come at you breaking news on a Monday. The Las Vegas Raiders have fired general manager Mike Mayock. Now, I promise you guys this all the time. News, rumors, 100% free. And even if it's my day off, I don't care. I'm giving you guys the content that you desire. So hit that sub button and turn on those notifications. That way you don't miss a thing. Now, the Raiders Report today is presented by a brand new sponsor that I am very, very excited to be able to talk about. Major shout out to Fetch Rewards. If anybody out there wants to go ahead and download this free app, all you got to do is go to chatsports.com/fetch. That's going to get you 3,000 bonus points. Now, for those of you wondering, well, why would I go ahead and download this? Has anybody ever bought anything? Has the cashier ever said, hey, do you want a receipt? Answer yes to that, and then you basically submit your receipts on this app where you can then get extra points, then get extra gift cards from places like Amazon, CVS. It's an awesome app. That link's going to be available for you on the comments and in the description. So the Las Vegas Raiders decided to move on from Mike Mayock after three seasons. Now, the new search is going to go ahead and begin. We're going to talk about some guys that they've already requested to interview at general manager. We're also going to be breaking down some of the people that they've requested to interview as a potential head coach. Now, the news broke on Monday, and I always like to say, and I say it all the time here, where there's smoke, there's probably going to end up being some fire. And a lot of smoke started happening on IG, on Twitter, all these places. And Ian Rapoport went ahead and tweeted, "General Manager Mike Mayock was informed that he won't be retained," sources said. "John Gruden resigned in October. Mayock now out in January." Then Adam Schefter, he chimed in with his two cents as well. "Unlike Mike Mayock, Raiders interim head coach Rich Bisaccia remains with the team at this time, but Las Vegas has submitted interview requests for at least one head coaching candidate." Now, yes, the one head coach candidate, which obviously we're going to get to here. They've also requested four other head coaching candidates, which they did probably about 2 months ago, maybe a month ago. But this is what the Raiders report's about. It's about giving you guys news, about giving you guys rumors. It's just about being diehard fans trying to collaborate together. So this is the opportunity where you guys can shine. I want you to go down in the comments section right now, and I want you to give me that one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. It can be a positive comment. It can be a negative comment. Whatever you're feeling is that initial knee-jerk reaction. My one-word reaction when I heard this, I was kind of like, buckle up. Not that I knew 100% that it was going to happen, but I started talking to some people, some of my friends in the industry. They were like, hey, I really truly believe that this is going to end up happening. So when I say buckle up, I mean it's going to be a very, very interesting next week or two. I mean, you could even look in 3 weeks, 4 weeks. The entire offseason is just going to be a time that I'm telling you, you're going to want to be subscribed here. You're going to be making sure that you have everything going on, because the next time that the Raiders announce who they're going to hire as a GM, I can guarantee you this, I'm going to be going live here on the Raiders Report. Now, I know I talked to you guys at the top of the show about Fetch, but I do want to say it one more time. Chuck loves this app, chatsports.com/fetch. It's free to download. You can kind of see how the app works here on the right side of me. You can take a picture of your receipt. You then upload it, and you can get rewarded for all of your shopping. So basically, let's just say you go ahead and you spend some money at a CVS. You scan that receipt. Then you can earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant. Like, guys, I'm telling you right now, super, super easy. So go to chatsports.com/fetch. Make sure you use promo code Raiders. Can you remember that? I know. It's right here on my sweatshirt. Promo code Raiders at chatsports.com/fetch to get 3,000 bonus points. So earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant, and then redeem those points for gift cards and other awesome rewards. Now, when you talk about Mike Mayock, everyone likes to say, all right, this guy was supposed to be, you know, I don't know, this draft guru from top to bottom. He could help us out. But, I mean, let's face it. These first-round picks, not so good. In fact, at times they almost take my breath away. Cleveland Furl, that's been an absolute bust. I love Josh Jacobs. He ran hell of a game this past week up against the Bengals. But running back's the easiest position to be able to replace. Jonathan Abram has absolutely not been worth a first-round pick, and he's going to be a guy that they say they're going to turn down his fifth-year option. Then in 2020, Henry Ruggs, trending in the right direction. Obviously, I can't really put that one against Mayock, but, you know, it is what it is now. Damon Arnett, if anybody watched more than 10 minutes of film on Arnett, and Mike Mayock said that they did more research than anybody, I foolishly would say then you're crazy for honestly drafting Arnett in the first or second round. He's been a bust, and in fact, he was released by the Miami Dolphins today. And then Alex Leatherwood, another player that I had a round two grade on, thought they reached on him just a little bit, but when you add up the drafts, and you add up some of the trades that did not work, the big-time signings like a Trent Brown and free agency, the Antonio Brown trade, they've had a lot of things that simply, you have to realize, have not worked in Mike Mayock's favor. Now, in terms of some other general manager interview requests, they've had Dane Ziegler, who is director of player personnel of the New England Patriots, Ed Dodds, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. As this time, these are the only two general manager requests that the Raiders have put in. I said on my show on Sunday that the top guy that I want the Raiders to go out and at least put in 2 cents with is Lewis Riddick. I know Lewis Riddick would be interested in being a general manager in the National Football League. I think it's only a matter of time until you start seeing some news around him. But as it stands right now, the leading candidate to be the next general manager of the Raiders is Ed Dodds, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. Now, if you don't like those two names there, I anticipate most people who are watching are probably going to go ahead and type LR for Lewis Riddick. I want to know, Who should be the next Raiders general manager? If anybody wants to say my name, hey, I'll submit it. I'm totally down to do it. I'd be more than happy to try to get this team on the right track. So who should be the next Raiders general manager? Now, we are going to shift our ship here to the head coach because we're going to be talking about Rich Bisaccia a whole lot. And if anybody ever wants to hit me up with anything, remember, you can always hit me up on IG at MitchellRen365. And on top of that, I've been posting a lot more news, a lot more just rumblings and stuff that I'm hearing on my Twitter and IG. So please don't be afraid to give me a follow. Now, here's another tweet coming in here from Ian Rapoport that says, the Raiders have a top in-house candidate in DeJuan Daniels, assistant director of player personnel. Mark Davis still plans to interview interim Rich Bisaccia for the head job. Crazy the team made the playoffs despite Gruden resigning, Ruggs, injuries, and so much more. Which, you're 100% right. I mean, the Raiders are the first team in 60 years. Yes, first team in 60 years, basically the first team since Super Bowl era, to make the playoffs when another coach on that team was let go. Also, the Raiders are only the second team since the 2000 Alliance to win at least 9 games. I know the Raiders won 10, but at least 9 games. Like, that's how great Rich Bisaccia has been for this team. Now, in terms of some early head coach interviews, you have Bisaccia, Gus Bradley, Leslie Frazier, Todd Bowles. The four names that you see right here, these were announced probably, I'm going to say, about a month and a half ago. And then the new name that just popped up today on Monday was Jerod Mayo, inside linebacker of the New England Patriots. I could also see some extra names, like, I think if you don't interview Brian Daboll, Kellen Moore, even extra names like a Byron Leftwich, if Mike Tomlin's available, Sean Payton, if he becomes available. I mean, there's going to be a lot of big names out there to potentially look at to be that next Raiders head coach. The issue is this, and not even an issue. If you were to ask me, Mitch, what's your gut feeling? And I'm feeling my gut right now, and it's who's going to be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. I've talked to very reliable sources, people even like James Yoder, who's very well connected with the Michigan Wolverines, and he said Jim Harbaugh right now is eyeing the Las Vegas Raiders. He also said that he's eyeing the Giants, but I've heard from multiple people that Jim Harbaugh could end up being absolutely the next head coach of the Raiders. And then you go out and you look at the Vegas odds. You look at all these other odds out there, and Harbaugh is the betting favorite to be the Raiders' next head coach. Now, there was a rumor circulating about a week and a half ago, 2 weeks, that the Raiders could potentially offer him $12 million. This also was kind of piggybacking off of another report that said that Harbaugh's gone silent in the Michigan football room, that, you know, apparently he didn't show up to a meeting in terms of discussing his long-term contract. I've been saying it for weeks. I've been turning my page on the fact that, hey, I actually wouldn't mind Jim Harbaugh. Now, this is a pretty interesting tweet. For those of you, I know, for those of you that don't know who Jumbo Elliott is, he was an old teammate of Harbaugh for like 14 seasons. Little birdie says Coach Harbaugh eyeing the Raiders and the Giants. All I'm saying is this, for an old friend, a good friend of Harbaugh, and an old teammate of his, all I got to say is for him to be tweeting out stuff like this, to me means that it's, you know, pretty well that he knows somebody, and the guy that he knows is Harbaugh. So, Elliott was a four-year teammate of Harbaugh at Michigan from 1983 to 86, two-time All-American, a 14-year NFL player with the Giants and Jets, and a 1993 Pro Bowler. He's very well connected, and he wouldn't just throw out a tweet like this if he didn't actually know. Now, if you were to ask me right now, who is the top head coach candidate for the Raiders, the most likely is Jim Harbaugh. He has had success wherever he has gone, which not a lot of coaches can say. When you look at the job that Harbaugh was able to do in San Diego, yeah, it was actually his first head coaching gig. He turned San Diego into a winning team, where they went 11-1, 11-1 the final 2 years. He took Stanford, that program, to a winning record. He took the Michigan Wolverines of late. They just took down Ohio State. He did it with San Francisco. They were 44-19-1 overall. If you were to ask me who is the front runner to be the next Raiders head coach, it is Jim Harbaugh. But I also will go ahead and say this. I want Rich Bisaccia back in that locker room. I want Rich Bisaccia back at Allegiant Stadium. I tweeted out at MitchellRens365 that Rich Bisaccia hand-wrote messages to every single Raiders player thanking them for basically just being dedicated to the game. I'm not sitting here saying that I want Bisaccia back as the head coach because, to be honest, I don't. But I would want Bisaccia back as the special teams coordinator, as your assistant head coach, and to reward him for really being a glue guy. I mean, when you hear people like Max Crosby, Derek Carr speak as highly as they do about Bisaccia, That goes a long way with me. So keep Bisaccia, give him extra money, make him that assistant head coach, and let's not go down a rabbit hole where you make one guy just the be-all in terms of a head coach. This is, needs to be a collective unit. Now, I appreciate everyone that's made it this far in the video. I know you're probably going to get ready for some Monday Night Football. Maybe you're going to go out and buy some food. If you buy some food, if you get a receipt, make sure you scan that. Free to download this app, chatsports.com/fetch. Just make sure you use promo code Raiders. That way you get some extra bonus points. That way you get some extra cards to go ahead and spend elsewhere. All right, y'all, go ahead. Shout out your city. Let me know where you're at. I don't know if you guys could tell, I had the worst tickle in the back of my throat, which is also top 10 weirdest things I've ever said on this show. If anybody knows what can help with a tickle in the back of my throat, please, can't wait to see what you have to say. Let me know where you guys are watching from. Shout out your city. We're going to go ahead now, and we're going to be answering some super chats, answering some questions. We've had a lot of stuff come up here on the show, and basically the more supers that come in, the more questions that we get. It's just the longer that I could stay live here on the show. I mean, like I said, today was my off day. Shout out to my team. Shout out to Harrison Graham, Chase Sr., Jeffrey Kubestein, Brett Scott, James Yoder, Tom Downey, Jeremy Biedling, Sam Brown. We got a hell of a team. Matthew Peterson. I'm trying to think, did I forget anyone? I don't know. But they put this entire show together. I was able to walk in today on my off day, and they were able to set it up. So major shout out to all of them. Now let's go. Shout out your city. What do we got here? What is that? Milpitasa, California from Richard. I don't know where that is. Madera, California. Santa Monica, California from Eric. Richmond, Virginia. Derek from Erica Salazar. Laren Moss says, teamwork. Landsberg, New York. Freeland, PA. B-I-L-O-X-I. I have no... Biloxi? Biloxi. I don't know, Mississippi. We have more coming in here. Let me know where you guys are watching from, and if you want to get a shout-out here on the show. We got Southgate. We got a North Carolina coming in from Tyler the Blaze, San Jose, California, Henderson, Nevada, Salinas, California, Utah from Raider B-Dog, Porterville, California, Hartford, Vegas, baby. So keep on coming in. Shout out your city. Let me know down in the comment section. And coming up right now, we're going to do a fun little like mailbag reaction to all the Mike Mayock news. So if you want to get featured on the show, the two ways to do it, hashtag Raiders, or you can go ahead and super chat. Once Brett gives me the thumbs up, we're going to go ahead. We're going to be answering all y'all's questions for the next maybe like 15 minutes or so. And then if the questions are good, if you guys are having a good time, which by the way, if you are having a good time right now, you're happy that we went live on the Raiders Report, please go ahead, like the video. Believe it or not, it does help us out a lot here. We are a free channel, and we do our best to be able to go ahead, keep you guys up to date on anything going on around the silver and black. So hashtag Raiders or Super Chat to get featured in this mailbag. Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report. The Las Vegas Raiders, they have moved on from general manager Mike Mayock. So what we're doing here on today's show is we're gonna react to it. This is a live instant reaction to Mike Mayock being fired from Raider Nation. So all the questions, all your comments is a knee-jerk reaction. So get ready. It's about to get wild. This first one's coming in from David Taken. I think the Raiders should re-sign Solomon Thomas, Denzel Perriman, Casey Hayward, hire Harbaugh, fire Olsen. All right, so Solomon Thomas, I would want him back on a much cheaper contract. Denzel Perriman's not a free agent. He's still got 1 year left on his deal. Casey Hayward's probably one of your top priorities. Yes, I like Harbaugh. Olsen's gone. Get rid of Parker. Brandon, he can still at least be a good depth piece. All right, let's go to Jeff. Derek Carr looks like a Lyle Zotto with the long hair. Yeah, he definitely needs to cut. He looks like the bad guy in all the Home Alone movies. Let's go to Zachary Rosfeld. I'm going to miss Leah Mayock the most. Yeah, she just tweeted out that it's official, and I don't know. I'm going to be honest. I'm not really going to miss her all that much. I'm going to miss her dad a lot more. He was a hardworking guy. I have a lot of respect for Mike, but I know what you're trying to do with this. I'm not going to get into a trap. I think Alex is watching home with Chuck, and that's just it's a nightmare. Let's go to Ben Sandoval. Wikipedia says that Lewis Riddick is the new GM. What's up? Believe it or not, I don't know if anybody has ever heard this, but you can actually just go on Wikipedia and you can change it. I could actually be the 47th president of the United States if I got credit. Now, sure, they can change it in 5 minutes, but shout out to the people that did that. And yeah, I would love to have Lewis Riddick as the next GM. Let's go to Alex Thompson. If Mitch, I did the BetUS Raiders 125 for the jersey, made my bet, got the email. Yeah, you just got to be a little bit more patient. We get hundreds and hundreds of emails. So if anybody out there hasn't already gotten the jersey hookup, chatsports.com/Raiders, promo code Raiders125 for that 125% deposit bonus. Alex, my team, we scrubbed through a whole bunch of emails, so just be patient, my man. If you haven't noticed, I post all the time a guy's getting their free jersey. So I promise you, you will end up getting it. I just need you to be, you know, just as long as you follow the instructions, you know, we're going to be good. That's really what it comes down to. If you went to chatsports.com/Raiders, if you use promo code Raiders125, if you got that bet in before the Raiders and Bengals game, you're good. Nothing to worry about. If you didn't do that, then that can get us down a little bit of a rabbit hole because then I don't get credit, which means then I can't get a free jersey for y'all. So that's basically just how it works. All right, y'all, so let it out. What is your one-word reaction to Mike Mayock being fired? My one-word reaction was buckle up because I knew, like, there's going to be a lot of crazy stuff that ends up happening here for the Las Vegas Raiders probably over the next day or two, probably over the next week. There's going to be a lot of stuff going down. So if you haven't yet, let me know down in the comment section your one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. All right, y'all, we're going to start giving some shout-outs here to some of the Super Chats that have come in. I got Celestial Leon says, if Jim Harbaugh becomes the new head coach for the Raiders, what do we got? I actually think that Harbaugh absolutely could be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. Next GM, Thomas Dimitroff. Maybe Daniel, I'm not 100% sure. We got Ryan Decker. Who do you think the Raiders select with the first pick? Still way. You got to see what happens in free agency. You got to see what happens with Derek Carr. But we're going to be making a lot of videos about all that stuff. Appreciate you, Ryan. Jonathan Perez, I know this is not on topic, but unless DC is willing to run the ball and do whatever it takes to win, he's got to go. My vote. My vote is this. If DC is willing to stay on 19.9, I am willing to give him another shot. If not, and he wants a contract extension, trade him for at least 2 first-round picks. And if you can't get 2 first-round picks, then there's a whole other issue. But I am not extending Derek Carr. Let's go to Adam. Is Davis making these decisions on his own? I don't have a good answer. I haven't talked to Mark Davis, but it does sound like he's doing a lot of stuff. Jonathan Perez, appreciate it. Demokes, bruh, make polling bum moves. Really going after Patriots people. That's something I expect from the Lions organization. I can understand that a little bit, but we'll see what ends up happening. Let's go to Ben Jenkins. If Devin White was picked instead of Ferrell, Mike would still had his job. I actually don't know if that's even 100% sure. The Cleveland Ferrell one was really bad. Do I just say it out loud? Just go with it? The Olsen? All right, sounds good. Ben Jenkins, appreciate it. I see another people also that are typing in their Super Chats. If I don't get to them, please just hit me up on IG or on Twitter, MitchellRants365, because they are really coming in. Peter Silva, I think we should trade Carr if he can somehow sign Rodgers. I mean, if there's some way you can get an upgrade at QB, like that's what you got to do. If you can get Watson, if you can get Wilson, if you can get Rodgers, yeah, I'm kind of on board for it. Demokes, this is the one I was kind of reading before. Same owner who fired a coach who took us 12-4 one year out. I get what Mark Davis is doing. I will say this. I've said for a long time, I know Al was one of the greatest ever, if not the greatest owner in all of the NFL. Like, you can really put that into the equation. Mark, though, needs people to have somewhere around him because he has really struggled making critical decisions. Now, to Mokes, I appreciate it. All right, y'all, Mike Mayock is no longer the general manager of the Las Vegas Raiders. And if you guys want to go ahead, if you're excited about the news, you can like the video if you like it. If you don't like the move, then please, I want you to vent your frustrations down below. Also, shout out to DVL35. If the Raiders hire a new head coach with players, will request to be released slash traded because they don't want to be a part of the rebuild. I mean, you might see some of that, but here's the other issue that a lot of players are going to face. The amount of teams, the amount of players that signed one-year contracts this past year because salary cap was going up, this is going to be an offseason that's going to have a lot of moving parts, a lot of stuff changing. Russell Wilson going to be on the move. Aaron Rodgers is going to be on the move. Like, there's going to be a lot of moving parts, and if teams want to go ahead and have that mentality, I don't think it's going to sit well with a lot of other people out there. Now, we went live here because Mike Mayock was fired today by the Las Vegas Raiders. I'm going to be live tomorrow at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific, so make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you turn on those notifications. Enjoy the rest of your Monday, and if you want to let me know who you got in tonight's game, you can type LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. One more Super Chat coming in from Gregory Vasquez. Is it true Olsen was fired? At this time, It's not true. Though, where there's smoke, there is fire. So please keep that in mind. And I say go for Devontae Adams no matter what. I am all on board for Devontae Adams, but it's going to take a lot of money. I'm probably going to say 25 mil. Enjoy the rest of your day. Let me know what you guys are thinking about Mayock. Let me know who you got tonight. LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. And if you haven't subscribed yet, click that big red button. This is why you subscribe to the Raiders Report. Why? Because we come at you breaking news on a Monday. The Las Vegas Raiders have fired general manager Mike Mayock. Now, I promise you guys this all the time. News, rumors, 100% free. And even if it's my day off, I don't care. I'm giving you guys the content that you desire. So hit that sub button and turn on those notifications. That way you don't miss a thing. Now, the Raiders Report today is presented by a brand new sponsor that I am very, very excited to be able to talk about. Major shout out to Fetch Rewards. If anybody out there wants to go ahead and download this free app, all you got to do is go to chatsports.com/fetch. That's going to get you 3,000 bonus points. Now, for those of you wondering, well, why would I go ahead and download this? Has anybody ever bought anything? Has the cashier ever said, hey, do you want a receipt? Answer yes to that, and then you basically submit your receipts on this app where you can then get extra points, then get extra gift cards from places like Amazon, CVS. It's an awesome app. That link's going to be available for you on the comments and in the description. So the Las Vegas Raiders decided to move on from Mike Mayock after three seasons. Now the new search is going to go ahead and begin. We're going to talk about some guys that they've already requested to interview at general manager. We're also going to be breaking down some of the people that they've requested to interview as a potential head coach. Now the news broke on Monday, and I always like to say, and I say it all the time here, where there's smoke, there's probably going to end up being some fire. And a lot of smoke started happening on IG, on Twitter, all these places. And Ian Rapoport went ahead and tweeted, general manager Mike Mayock was informed that he won't be retained, sources said. John Gruden resigned in October. Mayock now out in January. Then Adam Schefter, he chimed in with his two cents as well. Unlike Mike Mayock, Raiders interim head coach Rich Bisaccia remains with the team at this time, but Las Vegas has submitted interview requests for at least one head coaching candidate. Now, yes, the one head coach candidate, which obviously we're going to get to here. They've also requested four other head coaching candidates, which they did probably about 2 months ago, maybe a month ago. But this is what the Raiders Report's about. It's about giving you guys news, about giving you guys rumors. It's just about being diehard fans trying to collaborate together. So this is the opportunity where you guys can shine. I want you to go down in the comments section right now, and I want you to give me that one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. It can be a positive comment. It can be a negative comment. Whatever you're feeling is that initial knee-jerk reaction. My one-word reaction when I heard this, I was kind of like, buckle up. Not that I knew 100% that it was going to happen, but I started talking to some people, some of my friends in the industry. They were like, hey, I really truly believe that this is going to end up happening. So when I say buckle up, I mean it's going to be a very, very interesting next week or two. I mean, you could even look in 3 weeks, 4 weeks. The entire offseason is just going to be a time that I'm telling you, you're going to want to be subscribed here. You're going to be making sure that you have everything going on, because the next time that the Raiders announce who they're going to hire as a GM, I can guarantee you this, I'm going to be going live here on the Raiders Report. Now, I know I talked to you guys at the top of the show about Fetch, but I do want to say it one more time. Chuck loves this app. Chatsports.com/fetch. It's free to download. You can kind of see how the app works here on the right side of me. You can take a picture of your receipt. You then upload it, and you can get rewarded for all of your shopping. So basically, let's just say you go ahead and you spend some money at a CVS. You scan that receipt. Then you can earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant. Like, guys, I'm telling you right now, super, super easy. So go to chatsports.com/fetch. Make sure you use promo code Raiders. Can you remember that? I know. It's right here on my sweatshirt. Promo code Raiders at chatsports.com/fetch to get 3,000 bonus points. So earn points on any receipt from any store or restaurant, and then redeem those points for gift cards and other awesome rewards. Now, when you talk about Mike Mayock, everyone likes to say, all right, this guy was supposed to be, you know, I don't know, this draft guru from top to bottom, he could help us out. But, I mean, let's face it. These first-round picks, not so good. In fact, at times they almost take my breath away. Cleveland Furrell, that's been an absolute bust. I love Josh Jacobs. He ran hell of a game this past week up against the Bengals. But running back's the easiest position to be able to replace. Jonathan Abram has absolutely not been worth a first-round pick, and he's going to be a guy that they say they're going to turn down his fifth-year option. Then in 2020, Henry Ruggs, trending in the right direction. Obviously, I can't really put that one against Mayock, but, you know, it is what it is now. Damon Arnett, if anybody watched more than 10 minutes of film on Arnett, and Mike Mayock said that they did more research than anybody, I foolishly would say then you're crazy for honestly drafting Arnett in the first or second round. He's been a bust, and in fact, he was released by the Miami Dolphins today. And then Alex Leatherwood, another player that I had a round two grade on, thought they reached on him just a little bit, but when you add up the drafts and you add up some of the trades that did not work, the big-time signings like a Trent Brown in free agency, the Antonio Brown trade, they've had a lot of things that simply you have to realize have not worked in Mike Mayock's favor. Now, in terms of some other general manager interview requests, they've had Dane Ziegler, who is director of player personnel of the New England Patriots, Ed Dodds, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. As this time, these are the only two general manager requests that the Raiders have put in. I said on my show on Sunday that the top guy that I want the Raiders to go out and at least put in 2 cents with is Lewis Riddick. I know Lewis Riddick would be interested in being a general manager in the National Football League. I think it's only a matter of time until you start seeing some news around him. But as it stands right now, the leading candidate to be the next general manager of the Raiders is Ed Dodd, assistant GM of the Indianapolis Colts. Now, if you don't like those two names there, I anticipate most people who are watching are probably going to go ahead and type LR for Lewis Riddick. I want to know, who should be the next Raiders general manager? If anybody wants to say my name, hey, I'll submit it. I'm totally down to do it. I'd be more than happy to try to get this team on the right track. So who should be the next Raiders general manager? Now, we are going to shift our ship here to the head coach because we're going to be talking about Rich Bisaccia a whole lot. And if anybody ever wants to hit me up with anything, remember, you can always hit me up on IG at MitchellRen365. And on top of that, I've been posting a lot more news, a lot more just rumblings and stuff that I'm hearing on my Twitter and IG. So please don't be afraid to give me a follow. Now, here's another tweet coming in here from Ian Rapoport that says, the Raiders have a top in-house candidate in DeJuan Daniels, assistant director of player personnel. Mark Davis still plans to interview interim Rich Bisaccia for the head job. Crazy the team made the playoffs despite Gruden resigning, Ruggs, injuries, and so much more. Which, you're 100% right. I mean, the Raiders are the first team in 60 years. Yes, first team in 60 years, basically the first team since Super Bowl era, to make the playoffs when another coach on that team was let go. Also, the Raiders are only the second team since the 2000 Alliance to win at least 9 games. I know the Raiders won 10, but at least 9 games. Like, that's how great Rich Bisaccia has been for this team. Now, in terms of some early head coach interviews, you have Bisaccia, Gus Bradley, Leslie Frazier, Todd Bowles. The four names that you see right here, these were announced probably, I'm going to say, about a month and a half ago. And then the new name that just popped up today on Monday was Jerod Mayo, inside linebacker of the New England Patriots. I could also see some extra names like, I think if you don't interview Brian Daboll, Kellen Moore, even extra names like Byron Leftwich, if Mike Tomlin's available, Sean Payton, if he becomes available. I mean, there's going to be a lot of big names out there to potentially look at to be that next Raiders head coach. The issue is this, and it's not even an issue. If you were to ask me, Mitch, what's your gut feeling? And I'm feeling my gut right now, and it's who's going to be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. I've talked to very reliable sources, people even like James Yoder, who's very well connected with the Michigan Wolverines, and he said Jim Harbaugh right now is eyeing the Las Vegas Raiders. He also said that he's eyeing the Giants, but I've heard from multiple people that Jim Harbaugh could end up being absolutely the next head coach of the Raiders. And then you go out and you look at the Vegas odds, you look at all these other odds out there, and Harbaugh is the betting favorite to be the Raiders' next head coach. Now, there was a rumor circulating about a week and a half ago, 2 weeks, that the Raiders could potentially offer him $12 million. This also was kind of piggybacking off of another report that said that Harbaugh's gone silent in the Michigan football room, that, you know, apparently he didn't show up to a meeting in terms of discussing his long-term contract. I've been saying it for weeks. I've been turning my page on the fact that, hey, I actually wouldn't mind Jim Harbaugh. Now, this is a pretty interesting tweet. For those of you, I know, for those of you that don't know who Jumbo Elliott is, he was an old teammate of Harbaugh for like 14 seasons. Little Birdie says Coach Harbaugh eyeing the Raiders and the Giants. All I'm saying is this, for an old friend, a good friend of Harbaugh, and an old teammate of his, all I got to say is for him to be tweeting out stuff like this, to me means that it's, you know, pretty well that he knows somebody, and the guy that he knows is Harbaugh. So Elliott was a four-year teammate of Harbaugh at Michigan from 1983 to 86, two-time All-American, and 14-year NFL player with the Giants and Jets, and a 1993 Pro Bowl. He's very well connected, and he wouldn't just throw out a tweet like this if he didn't actually know. Now, if you were to ask me right now, who is the top head coach candidate for the Raiders, the most likely is Jim Harbaugh. He has had success wherever he has gone, which not a lot of coaches can say. When you look at the job that Harbaugh was able to do in San Diego, yeah, it was actually his first head coaching gig. He turned San Diego into a winning team, where they went 11-1, 11-1 the final 2 years. He took Stanford, that program, to a winning record. He took the Michigan Wolverines of late. They just took down Ohio State. He did it with San Francisco. They were 44-19-1 overall. If you were to ask me who is the front runner to be the next Raiders head coach, it is Jim Harbaugh. But I also will go ahead and say this. I want Rich Bisaccia back in that locker room. I want Rich Bisaccia back at Allegiant Stadium. I tweeted out at MitchellRens365 that Rich Bisaccia hand wrote messages to every single Raiders player thanking them for basically just being dedicated to the game. I'm not sitting here saying that I want Bisaccia back as the head coach, because to be honest, I don't. But I would want Bisaccia back as the special teams coordinator, as your assistant head coach, and to reward him for really being a glue guy. I mean, when you hear people like Max Crosby, Derek Carr speak as highly as they do about Bisaccia, that goes a long way with me. So keep Bisaccia, give him extra money, make him that assistant head coach, and let's not go down a rabbit hole where you make one guy just the be-all in terms of a head coach. This is, needs to be a collective unit. Now, I appreciate everyone that's made it this far in the video. I know you're probably going to get ready for some Monday Night Football. Maybe you're going to go out and buy some food. If you buy some food, if you get a receipt, make sure you scan that. Free to download this app, chatsports.com/fetch. Just make sure you use promo code Raiders. That way you get some extra bonus points. That way you get some extra cards to go ahead and spend elsewhere. All right, y'all, go ahead. Shout out your city. Let me know where you're at. I don't know if you guys could tell, I had the worst tickle in the back of my throat, which is also top 10 weirdest things I've ever said on this show. If anybody knows what can help with a tickle in the back of my throat, please, can't wait to see what you have to say. Let me know where you guys are watching from. Shout out your city. We're going to go ahead now, and we're going to be answering some super chats, answering some questions. We've had a lot of stuff come up here on the show, and basically the more supers that come in, the more questions that we get, it's just the longer that I could stay live here on the show. I mean, like I said, today was my off day. Shout out to my team. Shout out to Harrison Graham, Chase Sr., Jeffrey Kubestein, Brett Scott, James Yoder, Tom Downey, Jeremy Biedling, Sam Brown. We got a hell of a team. Matthew Peterson. Trying to think, did I forget anyone? I don't know. But they put this entire show together. I was able to walk in today on my off day, and they were able to set it up. So major shout out to all of them. Now let's go. Shout out your city. What do we got here? What is that? Mill Petisa, California from Richard. I don't know where that is. Madera, California. Santa Monica, California from Eric. Richmond, Virginia. Derek from Erica Salazar. Laren Moss says, teamwork. Landsberg, New York. Freeland, PA. B-I-L-O-X-I. I have no idea. Biloxi. I don't know, Mississippi. We have more coming in here. Let me know where you guys are watching from, and if you want to get a shout-out here on the show. We got Southgate. We got a North Carolina coming in from Tyler the Blaze, San Jose, California, Henderson, Nevada, Salinas, California, Utah from Raider B-Dog, Porterville, California, Hartford, Vegas, baby. So keep on coming in. Shout out your city. Let me know down in the comment section. Coming up right now, we're going to do a fun little like mailbag reaction to all the Mike Mayock news. So if you want to get featured on the show, the two ways to do it, hashtag Raiders, or you can go ahead and super chat. Once Brett gives me the thumbs up, we're going to go ahead. We're going to be answering all y'all's questions for the next maybe like 15 minutes or so. And then if the questions are good, if you guys are having a good time, which by the way, if you are having a good time right now, you're happy that we went live on the Raiders Report, please go ahead, like the video, believe it or not. It does help us out a lot here. We are a free channel, and we do our best to be able to go ahead, keep you guys up to date on anything going on around the silver and black. So hashtag Raiders or Super Chat to get featured in this mailbag. Raider Nation, what's going on? You're watching the Raiders Report. The Las Vegas Raiders, they have moved on from general manager Mike Mayock. So what we're doing here on today's show is we're gonna react to it. This is a live instant reaction to Mike Mayock being fired from Raider Nation. So all the questions, all your comments is a knee-jerk reaction. So get ready. It's about to get wild. This first one's coming in from David Taken. I think the Raiders should re-sign Solomon Thomas, Denzel Perriman, Casey Hayward, hire Harbaugh, fire Olsen. All right, so Solomon Thomas, I would want him back to on a much cheaper contract. Denzel Perriman's not a free agent. He's still got 1 year left on his deal. Casey Hayward's probably one of your top priorities. Yes, I like Harbaugh. Olsen's gone. Get rid of Parker. Brandon, he can still at least be a good depth piece. All right, let's go to Jeff. Derek Carr looks like a Lyle Zotto with the long hair. Yeah, he definitely needs to cut. He looks like the bad guy in all the Home Alone movies. Let's go to Zachary Rossfeld. I'm going to miss Leah Mayock the most. Yeah, she just tweeted out that it's official, and I don't know. I'm going to be honest. I'm not really going to miss her all that much. I'm going to miss her dad a lot more. He was a hardworking guy. I have a lot of respect for Mike, but I know what you're trying to do with this. I'm not going to get into a trap. I think Alex is watching home with Chuck, and that's just it's a nightmare. Let's go to Ben Sandoval. Wikipedia says that Lewis Riddick is the new GM. What's up? Believe it or not, I don't know if anybody has ever heard this, but you can actually just go on Wikipedia and you can change it. I could actually be the 47th president of the United States if I got credit. Now, sure, they can change it in 5 minutes, but shout out to the people that did that. And yeah, I would love to have Lewis Riddick as the next GM. Let's go to Alex Thompson. If Mitch, I did the bet US Raiders 125 for the jersey, made my bet, got the email. Yeah, you just got to be a little bit more patient. We get hundreds and hundreds of emails. So if anybody out there hasn't already gotten the jersey hookup, chatsports.com/Raiders, promo code Raiders125 for that 125% deposit bonus. Alex, my team, we scrubbed through a whole bunch of emails. So just be patient, my man. If you haven't noticed, I post all the time of guys getting their free jersey. So I promise you, you will end up getting it. I just need you to be, you know, just as long as you follow the instructions, you know, we're going to be good. That's really what it comes down to. If you went to chatsports.com/Raiders, if you use promo code Raiders125, if you got that bet in before the Raiders and Bengals game, you're good. Nothing to worry about. If you didn't do that, then that can get us down a little bit of a rabbit hole because then I don't get credit, which means then I can't get a free jersey for y'all. So that's basically just how it works. All right, y'all, so let it out. What is your one-word reaction to Mike Mayock being fired? My one-word reaction was buckle up because I knew, like, there's going to be a lot of crazy stuff that ends up happening here for the Las Vegas Raiders probably over the next day or two, probably over the next week. There's going to be a lot of stuff going down. So if you haven't yet, let me know down in the comments section your one-word reaction to Mayock being fired. All right, y'all, we're going to start giving some shout-outs here to some of the Super Chats that have come in. I got Celestial Leon says, if Jim Harbaugh becomes the new head coach for the Raiders, what do we got? I actually think that Harbaugh absolutely could be the next head coach of the Las Vegas Raiders. Next GM, Thomas Dimitroff. Maybe Daniel, I'm not 100% sure. We got Ryan Decker. Who do you think the Raiders select with the first pick? Still way. You got to see what happens in free agency. You got to see what happens with Derek Carr. But we're going to be making a lot of videos about all that stuff. Appreciate you, Ryan. Jonathan Perez, I know this is not on topic, but unless DC is willing to run the ball and do whatever it takes to win, he's got to go. My vote. My vote is this. If DC is willing to stay on 19.9, I am willing to give him another shot. If not, and he wants a contract extension, trade him for at least 2 first-round picks. And if you can't get 2 first-round picks, then there's a whole other issue. But I am not extending Derek Carr. Let's go to Adam. Is Davis making these decisions on his own? I don't have a good answer. I haven't talked to Mark Davis, but it does sound like he's doing a lot of stuff. Jonathan Perez, appreciate it. Demokes, bruh, make polling bum moves. Really going after Patriots people. It's something I expect from the Lions organization. I can understand that a little bit, but we'll see what ends up happening. Let's go to Ben Jenkins. If Devin White was picked instead of Ferrell, Mike would still had his job. I actually don't know if that's even 100% sure. The Cleveland Ferrell one was really bad. Do I just say it out loud? Just go with it? The Olsen? All right, sounds good. Ben Jenkins, appreciate it. I see another people also that are typing in their Super Chats. If I don't get to them, please just hit me up on IG or on Twitter, MitchellRants365, because they are really coming in. Peter Silva, I think we should trade Carr if he can somehow sign Rodgers. I mean, if there's some way you can get an upgrade at QB, like that's what you got to do. If you can get Watson, if you can get Wilson, if you can get Rodgers, yeah, I'm kind of on board for it. Demokes, this is the one I was kind of reading before. Same owner who fired a coach who took us 12-4 one year out. I get what Mark Davis is doing. I will say this. I've said for a long time, I know Al was one of the greatest ever, if not the greatest owner in all of the NFL. Like, you can really put that into the equation. Mark, though, needs people to have somewhere around him because he has really struggled making critical, critical decisions. Now, to Mokes, I appreciate it. All right, y'all, Mike Mayock is no longer the general manager of the Las Vegas Raiders. And if you guys want to go ahead, if you're excited about the news, you can like the video if you like it. If you don't like the move, then please, I want you to vent your frustrations down below. Also, shout out to DVO35. If the Raiders hire a new head coach with players, will request to be released slash traded because they don't want to be a part of the rebuild. I mean, you might see some of that, but here's the other issue that a lot of players are going to face. The amount of teams, the amount of players that signed one-year contracts this past year because salary cap was going up, this is going to be an offseason that's going to have a lot of moving parts, a lot of stuff changing. Russell Wilson going to be on the move. Aaron Rodgers going to be on the move. Like, there's going to be a lot of moving parts, and if teams want to go ahead and have that mentality, I don't think it's going to sit well with a lot of other people out there. Now, we went live here because Mike Mayock was fired today by the Las Vegas Raiders. I'm going to be live tomorrow at 6 p.m. Eastern Time, 3 p.m. Pacific, so make sure you hit the subscribe button. Make sure you turn on those notifications. Enjoy the rest of your Monday, and if you want to let me know who you got in tonight's game, you can type LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. One more super chat coming in from Gregory Vasquez. Is it true Olsen was fired? At this time, it's not true. Though, where there's smoke, there is fire, so please keep that in mind. And I say, go for Devontae Adams no matter what. I am all on board for Devontae Adams, but it's going to take a lot of money. I'm probably going to say 25 mil. Enjoy the rest of your day. Let me know what you guys are thinking about Mayock. Let me know who you got tonight. LAR for the Rams, ARI for the Cardinals. And if you haven't subscribed yet, click that big red button.